Cradles shall rock, heads shall roll. Your friend will let you crash on their couch, but it's just a little bit too small and it's going to hurt your back. You have entered the gauntlet! Yes, yes, roar, scream, scream, so we know that you are watching. You have entered the gauntlet, where blood is spilled as champions battle against gladiators most dangerous, where all of the fiercest champions are curious. What? Curious, where are the...
That's what I thought we were doing this on Friday.
Oh, no, curious, it's always Thursday, same time. Oh, what? I guess I'll have to do it myself. I thought that I could have some of the great on the nearest right on the nearest on the nearest.
Commander, where are we?
Who? Commander?
This isn't the McGinley?
No, this isn't.
Whom? What strange environment is this?
You are just on the bridge. Captain, our phasers.
Missing.
Our tricorders are gone as well.
Who?
Who are you?
Who am I? I am a Montioc, giver of skulls, hander out of fun pamphlets.
Where's your shirt?
This is my shirt. This is what shirts look like in the gauntlet. What about your shirt? Who are you? Who are these strange beings? Right? Well, I was supposed to summon the Marakians of the dimension known as Muluhahor.
I have no idea, Master. Why are they wearing those strange outfits?
We're the crew of the USS McGinley. Are we being held here against our will?
Against your will? I'm afraid, sort of.
Commander. What shall we do about this?
Well, I'm afraid that you have been caught, it appears, in a stream, a dimensional stream. I was trying to summon warriors from a dimension different than you, but in the process, it seems as though I have crossed with a symbol I have seen before. Are you not of Starfleet?
Yes,
we are. Commander,
yes.
Do you think this could be a cue?
The Q continuum keeps a knocking down my door, and let's just say I ain't buying the cookies, fellas.
I think that means yes.
But I'm afraid that you now are the champions, and no one can leave the gauntlet unless they battle their way out. So, to all of those watching in the arena, and to those of you at home looking for blood, looking for battle, these are our champions for the night, so let's get to know them. Introduce yourselves to the crowd.
My name is Commander Jack Deadman. I serve aboard the USS McGinley, and I am also, my name is also, I've often been called Lucky Jack. I'm not very lucky at saying it, apparently.
Ah, Lucky Jack. But let us see if his luck holds when in a realm full of turmoil and triumph known as the Gauntlet!
It's obnoxious.
You there, man of the pointy ears, or should I say, of Vulcan?
Huh. Fascinating.
I know Montioc is the seer of all. He knows these kinds of things. He even knows what you had for breakfast. That's right, Greg. I know that it was a bowl of trick cereal. On to you, sir. Tell the people who you are.
I am Chulok. I serve as the counselor aboard the USS McGinley. It is my job to keep my crewmates mentally strong. Fortitude, if you will.
Fortitude will be important when coming down and facing against the gladiators of the continent. Yes, this one.
I'm Lieutenant Janie Boots, Chief Engineer of the USS McGinley. About 40% of that engine is Starfleet regulation, about 60% is my own ingenuity. Sorry, Commander, you didn't know that. Luckily, Q or whatever you are, I happen to have dilithium crystals in my hand when you beamed us down here. We've got a little bit of Starfleet to throw right back at you.
Well, they will come in handy, for dilithium crystals do harness a power that can cross dimensional barriers unlike anything else I have ever seen. This is a crew to be reckoned with. They will be stacking up skulls, I am sure, upon entering the gauntlet. Finally, you.
Ensign Cassiopeia Snow, I've been serving aboard the USS McGinley for 3 years now. I proudly serve as the ship's pilot, and I am eager to fly us out of this as soon as we win it, apparently.
Yes, you will need to win it. For these are your champions for the night, and while they may be out of their comfort zone, they have each other. A camaraderie bonded from heart to bone. Now, for those of you at home watching, this is the Gauntlet, a gladiatorial battle where they will face against gladiators and minions.
Wait, now, if we're gonna fight, Then what are we going to do without our phasers?
Without your phasers? Well, look to your feet. Do you not see finely crafted weaponry?
Oh, yes, I do.
Aha! Yes, you might not have your blasty machines, but you do have axe and sword and shield and perhaps your own mouths full of pointy teeth. Yes! Now, for those of you at home, if you are watching, you may help or hinder these heroes in their quests. That is right. If you want to help these officers of Starfleet, you may donate 25 of your Earth or Vulcan or Klingon dollars for #trap, and it will harm them. If you want to help them, #potion, and they will be aided. If you want to create your own idea that will be forever entered into the deck of potions or traps, 50 of your Earth dollars will get you a #custom trap. And if you are feeling so insane and crazy, like someone who was dropped onto the ground and then beaten continuously until the very fabrics of their mind did crumble, you may break the rules of the gauntlet for a #Uber trap. Named for the villainous, heroic, crazy person that no one knows actually if he even exists, called Ubaldi, and that is for 75 of your Earth dollars. Aha! The first thing.
#trap side effect, feathers, location and quantity dictated by whims of Amontiac.
Ah, location Amontiac can destroy it. Ah, yes. Now, the game is about to begin. It appears as though Gryphon Agent has sent to us feathers. Feathers that will probably spring forth from one of you, but we have yet to enter the game, but that will be the first of the traps that are administered for the night. Now, you understand the game. We shall see. Will they be able to gather skulls? Skulls, that is right. That is how we will accumulate their worth. And if they are able to beat 228 skulls, they will join me in my battle against the Dark Lord known as Krathicus Raktok, who for every moment draws near, his wings ever flapping, his beak ever clipping like this. And he gathers all the winged creatures of Deiros to come and kill us, the two-leggers, but we will stop him, for Amontiac will not allow such a thing to happen, for I have plans next year, and I do not wish to die. But now, enough out of me! Let us see battle! Let us see blood! We have entered the gauntlet! Before things begin, blood has already been shed, for a trap has been administered, and the sweet dice of destiny shall decide which one of you fine souls will get such a thing. Aha! The Vulcan. Hmm. The Vulcan. Now, no logic.
Careful, Tulak.
I am certain I can handle this.
It's just feathers.
The Vulcan
feathers,
is
after
certain,
all.
But as he looks out, an extra lethal serpent jolts out of the waters below. And it attacks. Ah! Oh my! This is a grim, grim attack! Now, you must roll of yourself a 30 reflex save. A 30 reflex save, or you will die.
5 plus 3.
You just weren't built for combat, Tulak.
I suppose not. Can't I talk to this creature and see if I can convince it not to hurt me?
I will allow it.
Dear creature, I...
It doesn't work! The serpent jumps and snacks onto your neck! And you frivol about! And as it goes, it turns out that this is not just a normal serpent, but a serpent that is full of a deadly poison, and suddenly the Vulcan doth crumble. He crumbles inside of himself, and then he starts spewing out pointy feathers.
Ew, why?
Feathers. Oh no. He is a griffin. A griffin! And the griffin starts to attack all of his mates. Ah, he goes to the commander and administers 2 points of damage are dealt, but he is able to throw it off of himself. When it comes to Janie Boots,
I will eat you for dinner if you don't give him back!
Oh, and while she takes for dinner, but in the process, she takes 1 point of damage. And finally, coming over to. And when it happened, quick, roll of a d20. If you can get over a 10, it will stop.
18!
18, she is saved!
What took you guys so long?
And then she uses the axe and hack it. Hack it, quick.
Chulak!
I know, I'm just taking the feathers off. Feather.
Just pluck him.
This is faster.
Got any hot water?
Here's some dilithium crystals. It'll heat him right up.
No, but I'm afraid he is dead.
Oh.
Was it my axe or was it?
No, he was already dead.
Commander!
He wasn't your Vulcan friend. He was the griffin snake that killed him. Now, if one of you fine souls out there could find it in your heart to subscribe, the Vulcan shall return.
Oh, come on, a trap right at the top? That's not fair!
Yes, well, nothing is fair in the gauntlet. No, not even...
Is this what you want? Us fighting against each other? Battling against each other?
Yes, well, when you face down Krathicus Rakhtok, things will not be as easy. For he is not fair, he is not kind. In fact, next to him, I am like a mother cradling 10 babies in one crib. No, outside is much more dangerous than in here. So, what would you do, Master? Would you step forth and issue your battle attack? Or will you weep and shed a tear for a man who has no tears of his own? Move forward, Commander. The gauntlet has begun.
This is no game I want to play, Jack.
I don't think we have a choice.
I don't mind it, actually, as long as we can get Chulak back. Sounds exciting.
We'll get him back.
Maybe. I expect we'll probably see him soon. Or maybe never. What? All right, you find yourselves in the Hall of Heroes, finally coming to your senses, feathers still flattering around in the room. But then, finally, a glimmering of light in the corner. We see that there are the statues in the Hall of Heroes, the statues of champions who did not survive the gauntlet.
Jack, he looks like you.
Well, I'm still here, so it's just a sexy resemblance.
Ah. Yes. Now, what moves do you make, sir?
I will go towards this, I don't know what creature that is. I'll go right towards it. And,
that is Faru the Old.
I will attack Faru the Old. With these two daggers that I have, and
excellent.
14.
14. I am afraid that the daggers—they do not quite pierce it.
Bad luck, Jack. You should have sharpened them.
It seems as though his luck has turned. Will his luck turn around again? It does not quite penetrate. Boots.
All right. I come straight up to this little golden creature. Reminds me of a little creature that I've seen on Deck 7 before. Pretty cute. Been thinking about asking him out for a drink. And I pick up my dilithium, and I rub it against my hands. I've got gloves on, just to cool them up a little bit. I will, what you, I believe, call an icy ray, but I'm going to call them dilithium hands.
Aha!
What was that?
Stop, collaborate, and listen. Trogaff is back with a brand new invention. You are no strangers to lover hashtag custom trap. You see a little silhouette of a goblin. Scaramouche doing the fandango. Suddenly thunderbolts and lightning dealing 66 damage to party.
Trogaff, the goblin coordinator. Oh, fresh off of a frothy gauntlet Grog has gotten his fun pants on, and he has decided to deal damage to you all. Now, I am afraid that 6d6 to each player has been dealt.
6d6 to each.
Yes,
to
you each must roll of a d6. That's your voice,
is your view, Roland.
I will do it instead. Thank you, Rycurious. Rycurious always keeping us on track. Now, Trogaff leads his little horde, and he runs through. Aha! But again. Hawk.
I love this place.
Hashtag potion side effect. Subject emits a faint glow for 10 minutes or until death.
Interesting. Huh? That they do. But first, the damage is dealt.
Thank you.
6d6 holy macaroons. 5. 5 times 6 is 30, correct?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Rycurious. And 4 times 6 is 24.
Master, yes. You are the best.
Yes, my timetables have paid off. Of course, I know how to do the nines. You just drop the finger. You guys know the move. Alas! 24 damage dealt you.
Oh.
30 dealt to you and you. Aha! Trogaff has spoken. And there he goes, going off. And he didn't even really care to harm you guys. He's on his way to a party. Have fun, Trogaff. See you around the bend. But now, Aha! A potion! Ooh. Someone is a friend!
Thank you.
Griffin Argent decides that friendliness is in store. But who? But to who?
I believe it's pronounced Agent Master.
What did I say?
Argent.
Well, you know, words. Who even uses them anymore?
Now, math is hard. To,
what was your name? Your name was Snow.
Yes.
Snow. Snow. What is your rank?
I am an ensign.
Ensign Snow.
She's our helmsman.
Ah, well, you know, somebody's got to drive the ship. I mean, what are you going to do? Just go nowhere? Drink yourself of a sweet potion. Drink it down as if it were lotion, and then you shall get a parchment made of potion.
How do you know that's not poison?
How do I know it's not poison?
You don't, but what are you going to do? Ignore the rules of the gauntlet?
Thank you. Q have to lie, anyway.
Q, do not demean my skills, such as a Q. For a Q is but a nebula trapped in a distant world. He has no mission. I, for one, am gathering an army to battle the forces of Krathicus Raktok, and I have a mission true.
Okay, so wizard. I'm going to enjoy this now?
Thank you.
I think you will love it. It is fine. It's just, it's very good. It's locally made.
Like a Bajoran sunrise, huh?
Oh my goodness, it's fantastic.
Yes.
You know thank what? You.
Thank you. Thank you. Rycurious, well they done. Like the new brew.
Well done.
Mark that. Mark that as good. Ah, oh yes, he's right. Yes, it's supposed to be give you a little bit of a hua.
It does. I feel like I might be shining.
Now
like,
come.
Like I'm in love
pick
with something.
A little glow pick, on your
yeah.
face.
Pick
nice.
You of a potion parchment.
Well, am I glowing or am I not glowing?
Yes, you are.
I'm there also glowing.
Glow, yes.
Like a love glow?
You're emitting a faint glow.
So that was called the skull smoothie, and I gained 2d12 skulls.
Holy magic!
Nice, d12! Nice.
That is lovely!
Which is this
yep.
one.
Yes, and make sure you clear the little thing. D12, not just M&M's for
a big
back.
11.
All
nicely
right.
done.
Who was the guy who gave me the potion? Oh!
Subscriber! Subscriber. I feel I can't control myself.
Oh!
I feel like this is being forced upon me.
What is going on? My limbs have been taken over.
This is unkind.
Ugh.
This is cruel.
I haven't danced since I was 12, Commander.
I love it. Masuma, Masuma, Masuma.
Ah, thank you, Catamon.
That was
and
cool.
then, suddenly, like in search for Spock, what was that planet?
That was the, I can't remember.
The planet in search for Spock, which resurrected him. It is happening now, for a subscriber has come in, and the Vulcan has sprung back to life.
Oh, Tulak!
Tulak, what did you see on the other side?
I'm sorry about the axe.
Another!
Ow!
Subscriber.
Welcome back, Tulak.
It is a pleasure to be here.
Tulak, I've never seen you dance like this before.
I've never been so compelled as I have been when I have been resurrected. Masuma, Masuma, Masuma.
That was Coffee Boya.
Coffee Boya. Copy Boya, yeah. Thank you so much for joining us at Hyper RPG.
You still
a
have
place
one
where
role
everybody
left.
Lives in a house and braids each other's hair.
We're getting,
now,
we're getting our workout
you
today.
Have entered the gauntlet, a gladiatorial battle where these fine officers of Starfleet have been interdimensionally sucked into a Montiox lair. Now, yes, it was the planet Genesis. Genesis was the name of the planet. And like that planet, we have now a Vulcan resurrected. Now, roll of your skulls. What was the first
She's already
roll?
Got 11.
11.
11, a very good roll.
And a 2.
And a 2, 13.
It's gonna be 13
a kind
skulls.
Of
the first one was great,
Vicurious. Did you hear that?
Is it?
Yes,
aha.
Is it Vicurious?
Rycurious. So is he also a Q?
None of us are Q.
We don't believe that.
Disease.
Oh.
Yes, with Z's, which stands for these people are crazy. You know what I'm saying?
We're the crazy ones.
Your omnipotence could use some help with the jokes.
You think so? All right, now, think you're so smart, do you? Fancy people in fancy uniforms? Well, guess what? There are still many minions in the lair, and they do launch an attack. And every single one of them hits. Four of them are there.
Did you have your roll yet?
I haven't hit. I just got skulls, but I didn't get an opportunity to kick this statue's ass.
Ah, then take it.
All right, I'm here to protect my commander because he's our ranking officer, and I swing my hammer down on this poor, unfortunate golden boy here.
Ah.
Oh, and I gotta do things.
Fancifully.
13 plus 12.
Ah, a hit! Huh. A hit indeed!
Well done, Ensign.
This is a 10? No?
That is a 10.
Great.
Wait, I didn't finish my turn.
7 plus... Oh. You didn't do your turn?
I didn't finish it.
It's okay,
it.
7 plus.
7 plus.
Get the thing off us.
16.
16.
Dead!
Nice.
So I have another... I come back up with the axe at this statuette. That is not as intimidating, because I have two hits.
Now you roll the d6. Oh, you're doing your two hits.
I get my two hits.
On you go.
Two.
Isn't it dead?
Yes, you've killed one. Now you move to the next.
Can I move to the next one?
Yeah, you do.
Great.
Because I know how to fight.
Yes, you do.
I've got a 19 plus seven, which is... That's not a 19,
yep,
is it?
No, you're good. 19
plus seven,
you're pretty
which
much
is
hit, 26. We're earlier. We're good. There it is.
Ha, with the 10 damage.
10 damage, and it is dead.
Whoa!
Z, whatever you are, I didn't complete my damage on my creature.
Oh, then go for it.
Thank you.
He plays by funny rules.
3 minus 1 is 2.
It lives. The beast lives! But now the beasts do attack. Well, one of their foes has gone, and even though they are trapped in gold, they can still kind of struggle underneath like this.
Interesting.
That makes sense.
I could try to get them out.
Two hits.
No, thank
two
no, necessary no. Boots.
Hits. Nope. The first to the Falcon, freshly resurrected.
We're
going
to have to do some healing for you.
Yes.
The second to Janie Boots. The damage.
Look out, Janie.
4, 6.
Oh! I don't mind.
Moving like statue, they do step forth. Oof. Using their golden spear. He throws it and then it pierces into the Vulcan's shoulder. And then it slightly pierces into Janie Boots as well. Plucking them against the wall. And it is not so damaging, but the damage is done still.
Even though it had thrown something into me, I'm so curious. It would simply take a simple oxygen plus hydrogen mixture to melt the gold a little bit to get them out.
We don't want to
Again,
do that.
Again, we don't want to get them out.
But it'd
Janie.
Be so interesting.
No, but
this is the wrong place for Janie to be.
Yes, it is.
Yes, science class. Here we
Can
are.
Can we move
again.
Across to him and flank those two beasts that are attacking them?
How much was the damage?
It could happen.
All right, we'll do that.
Do it.
Yeah.
Do it. No, move forth. Move forth, Commander. For the Hall of Heroes is a true place of kind of a testing ground.
Commander, try to ask him how he feels.
Yep, I'm going to do that right after I stab it in the back with these two daggers.
Sounds like the Deadman way.
Oh!
Natural 20.
Oh!
I have a feeling that's a good thing.
Roll again, see if we can get crit.
Critical mass?
Critical mass.
Oh, 8.
Not quite, but still a good roll.
Yes.
Lovely, you hit the creature.
Yes. Damage would be plus, oh, I gotta remember that one, don't I? Yes, I got it. That 12.
12, it is dead. Ha. Your double daggers this time pay off. And you pierce it perfectly in the spine. The spine, everyone's most sensitive spot. And it crumples and it just folds into like a tiny envelope and then it just lands in your hand. And you open it up and you read it. And inside it says,
please Roll. Ask Z to keep it down. Strange.
Hmm. I'm curious.
What,
I believe that the ghost of Zacchaeus is trolling us again inside of the realm.
Strange.
Can we see about the necromancers fixing that?
Amantiak, yes. Do we not get skulls
you
for know, having?
You do, you do.
Fantastic.
What about for the previous ones? Did we get skulls for those?
I think you already did.
Well, no.
What?
We only got skulls for my potion.
Did you not roll
and
for
I've
others?
Killed two statues that we didn't roll skulls. Oh.
Listen, if you're gonna drag us into this game.
Huh?
She is correct.
Listen, someone's gotta have logic here, and I think it's me.
So roll! Roll them both! Sometimes this is hard to keep track of.
Is it a D
but
what?
It is my job, six? For I am the Gauntlet Master. Roll of a D6 twice.
Four.
Well done.
Oh, they boo. Ah, boo yourselves.
Six.
Nicely
That's
done. Nicely
boo
done.
Yourselves, you mean, mean, awful things.
So I got 10. Yep, Lovely. Sure did.
Ah, 10! 10 skulls to the Lord, my goodness!
I do question the value of skulls.
And you know what? And you know what?
I see.
Take a D4 of skulls, just for my own mistakes.
D4 of skulls.
Interesting, Amantiak. I might be turning into someone who might not hate you.
Ah, lovely.
Do we accept generosity from a snake? That's the question.
Big 4! Nicely done!
4 more skulls!
Big 4!
4 more skulls!
Yes!
Yes.
Are you picking up anything from this wizard creature non-ZQ mind? Anything that can help us in defeating him?
His mind is very confusing. There's no sense to it. It is very random and strange.
It's a lot like his dialogue.
Yes.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Not far away from how I thought.
On to you, sir. You killed and you
slayed.
Yes,
there's only one left, yes?
And you've gone your turn. And you
I
got
have
your
indeed.
Skulls.
I killed it a moment ago.
You we didn't do your skulls for that,
oh,
though.
No skulls, yes, hi.
Three more skulls of the bull, right, Curious? Or Destinius, whoever's clipping the clopping, blah, bloom. Lovely. Now to the Vulcan.
Yes. I notice a loose rock by the edge of the wall. I grasp it in my hand. As gold is a very soft metal, this rock should do a great job of bashing the skull of the statue.
Ask it how it feels while you're doing it, though.
Yes,
it
I
enjoys
certainly
being
will.
In there.
All right.
17 plus
hit.
8.
A fine hit.
You got it?
Wonderful.
Yes, the rock D8. Is an extra smashy thing, and it does do the damage you wish.
Five!
It is dead. It crumbles before your feet. Tell us, how do you what happens as it falls before you?
Well, as the skull strikes its, or as the rock strikes its skull, the metal indents and drives the eyeballs out straight through, ooh, bursting two holes in the golden skull.
That's my disgusting.
My, oh my.
Interesting.
Now that the golden skull has been squishity dishitied, now dish out yourself your own skulls. Roll you over
d6.
Two.
I don't trust this sound anymore.
Hashtag trap petitioner supplicates a Monique to involve glitter.
Glitter?
Yes,
you don't
indeed.
Like glitter.
A trap.
I
a
love
trap
glitter.
Has been set. Now, when you have pulled that brick forward, yes, it was good for smashing of skulls and golden, true, but behind it is something most dangerous. That is right, behind it is an extra painful, depressing sandwich. And there it sits.
An actual flappy, sandwich?
An actual sandwich. Ooh.
Jack, don't.
And all.
Kind of hungry.
All of them reaching forth. For you can't but help it. It is alluring.
I'm most hungry.
And spores do burst from it. And then they enrapturedly go around your spinal cortex. And then you all each take a corner of the sandwich and take one but delicate bite. A cup.
Reminds me of my favorite neural transmitter
that
I built myself.
But, and while it reminds you of your favorite neural transmitter, it is in fact something much more awful and much more poisonous. Mm. And then suddenly, glitter. Glitter all over your mouths and faces. And it starts to burn. Yes. And you get 16. Now 2d8 plus.
It's in my eyes.
21 points of damage dealt to each member of the party.
Never looked so good feeling so bad.
Those sandwiches? Yes, you know, just to make things fun.
Commander!
And you know what? I bet that happened. How did the sandwiches Janie, taste? Pretty good?
I don't think the glitter's got me.
I think it's got me too, Commander. I'll see you on the other side. If there is another side. Jack!
Sorry, Ensign. I gotta go on this adventure on my own.
Hey!
Actually, we're gonna go together.
Both of you? Yeah. Listen!
I quickly use mind to mind contact Vulcan mind meld to heal Jack for 30 points of damage.
Thanks a lot, Chulak!
Don't take it personally.
I'm
only do
taking
it
personally.
He was closer to me.
Yes, that's all it was.
And he brings it back to life!
Yes, so technically he cannot heal it, but you have a resurrection. So that.
Oh, he can't heal
it. So you still can heal it yet, later.
Oh.
I can't, he can't
apparently,
use
I was wrong.
He can use his power and powers to heal someone, but not someone who's already dead.
I'm see. Afraid it doesn't work, but it does in this instance. But it happens is it brings it back to life. Well, we have an auto resurrection.
Emotional turmoil here with my crew being dead and alive.
Yes, Janie Boots. Janie Boots sits there, but you are so attached to her that you do carry her on your back like a backpack.
Oh God.
Because now you have slain all of the golden statues, and you want to bury her properly. Bury her properly. In their grave plot, you know, the one by the river, where all of the birdies do gather, where all of the ducks do eat all the bread that the old men feed them. But now, suddenly, as the tears do drip on the waters are activated, and you all are sucked through the skull fountain,
no.
And it swirls you around like a whirlpool.
Blip-a-boom! Ah, now, as it comes through, you spring forth into this room over here. You look around. What do you see?
A sarcophagus?
Yes, a sarcophagus.
We can leave her here just for the moment.
Indeed. Yes, rest Janie Boots' corpse.
And we'll put her on this throne.
There is an empty sarcophagus here. You place her there, but oh no, you have put her into the throne of King Kangkuk. For in this room you have found where the former master of this castle does lay his bones, and springing quick comes his eternal guardian. Yes, you have found the bone guardian Minotaur, known as Cut Ra! Katra!
Are you about done? We have to get back.
Placing the dead bones of another in the lair of the kings. I don't understand why Cutlot has all of a sudden not just but the living creatures who try to come and disturb the bones of the master, sir, but another corpse.
Ha, Cutlot, he has always been here, back when he was a flesh minotaur. For as you may know, the gauntlet itself takes place in the hollowed out castle of King Kenkuk, which I commandeered because he died centuries ago. But Cutlot has always remained here. I did not bring him in here. He was here before.
Is there like a coffee table book we could take back with us and kind of go over that later?
Or? Perhaps. I don't know. I mean, I think maybe it's been checked out.
Yeah?
Yes.
Is there like a whole library we could check into?
We'll see if we have time for it.
Right. Great.
But alas, whose turn was it?
Oh, mine.
Please, Commander, Cutrot comes forth. Now, keep in mind that as Cutrot springs forth, the other skeletal beasts do as well, and they all, shoom, they are his army, and they come to attack you, and they mean business. Do you wish to attack the minions, or do you attack
I'll Cutrot? Attack the first minion.
All right. Excellent move.
17.
17. It is a hit.
6 points of damage.
Ah, dead. What do you do to it? You have your two daggers.
Immediately, as soon as that bamfs into the middle of the room, I launch towards the first minion that comes to life, and I pierce the double daggers into it and snap off its head.
Oh, and the head flies up into the air, and as you all watch it go, ooh, it comes back down, and it lands back on its head, but it lands so heavily that all of the bones quickly crumble like one of those little toys where you push the bottom, you know? Uh-huh. It's like that. It is dead. Roll six.
Wow,
D6 for
Jack?
Skulls.
I didn't know you were so good
one.
With daggers.
One. One skull to the bones! Oh, my goodness.
That's all right, Jack. You're still good for a roll elsewhere.
That's right.
Yes, now, they are feeling the battle starting to come to life. We now move to the Vulcan.
Yes. I...
Attack the next minion?
Yes, I shall move. One, two...
No, that's not you.
That's not me. I am here. I shall turn around and attack this minion behind me.
You move forward.
Now. I will use my bare hands and use a Vulcan pinch.
Vulcan pinch. Let's see if it pinches properly.
8 plus 8, 16.
16 is a hit.
Nice.
Aha.
Fine hit, the Vulcan pinch. Wow, there are no nerves there. You do find the bone nerves, which are a whole other kind of nerve that most people don't know about. Now, do you kill it? Let us find out. Roll for damage.
Ooh.
4 plus 5, 9.
Nice job.
Dead.
Chula,
yes.
I like you in battle.
I'm impressed.
Now, when you do a Vulcan nerve pinch, it may make a creature unconscious. But when you do a bone nerve pinch, it makes something disintegrate. And it disintegrates into a sweet pile of dust. And you all gotta breathe it in. But it's okay. It's fine. Now, roll for skulls.
Skulls!
Four skulls to the board, right, curious!
Nice. Nicely done.
The ensign, now feeling the bubble of her
Come
blood.
Come on, Snow.
Sees all of the darkness enthralled around her and knows that survival is necessary and it must go down.
And someone must avenge Janie Boots. It's like we never forgot she was here.
We never forgot she was here.
And I will use my whirlwind attack to attack both Cutrock and the puny minion.
Very well. Right. He sees your axe and he's jealous of it because his is so old that he never got a new one like King Kenko promised him.
Nice! Big roll. Good job.
Plus, is it plus 12 as well? Or no?
Yes.
Fantastic. Plus 12. Ah. So I whirl my
axe. Yeah, it hits Cutrot.
It hits Cutrot?
It hits Cutrot.
That's an 8. That's a 10.
That's a
3. 3.
12. Tell us, what does it do to the creature?
As I whirl my axe around, it creates a literal whirlwind. and I bring up the minion into a tornado, but I hit his ribcage. I hit Cutrock's ribcage. That's what I did.
My very front of my chest is now broken into pieces, but you will pay for it.
And it comes forth, and you wanted to do your second attack against the minion?
Oh, I do, even though I did a whirlwind, that'd be great. So in this moment, I don't want to use my axe, and I just want to kick him. So we're going to do that with a 2. Plus 7, which is a 9. I feel like that potion must have been a little bit alcoholic.
You think so?
Yeah, maybe.
Master, I'm afraid I must come to fix a lock.
In comes Rycurious.
What the? This is madness!
Oh, no! Suddenly, she has been swept away.
The rules of this land make no sense to me.
She has been swept away by a necromancer to have her vocal communication box fixed. But alas, Cutrot has felt his first blood drawn.
Yes!
But now the battle turns. The battle turns against you, Chulok and Lucky Jack.
We're ready.
All right, the first two minions, their strikes do not hit. Back to back. You do ting, ting,
king, king.
You ward them off as two skeletal creatures do come at you. Yes, lovely. But now Cutrot administers a room attack, wishing to hit everyone in there.
Why do they always try to come and disturb me? Again,
16 plus 8 is 24. It is a hit. It is a hit indeed. Cutrot has hit all of you.
What?
He has
just in time
sliced
for that?
Through. He slices the top of your pants, and you get a little cut on your leg, kind of like the Riker toy. Do you remember it?
I should have stayed off for that.
An extra, yeah.
Yeah.
And the damage that is dealt. Let us discover the damage that is dealt is. It's not too bad. 12 points of damage dealt to all of the players of the gauntlet.
I'm not doing so good over here, guys.
Oh, yes.
Well, at least you're doing better than Janie Boots.
Yes, Janie Boots. The corpse of Janie Boots does rot in the corner. But in the gauntlet, rotting happens extra quick.
Oh, God.
But also there are magics that can heal these things. Is there not but a subscriber out there that would hit that button, join the new community of friends and services, and resurrect Janie Boots, the Starfleet officer? Let us find out in the moments to come. But for now, we turn to Commander Lucky Jack.
All right, I will. There's one more minion left, yes?
There's a single minion.
Did I not kill that guy?
No, he killed the other one, so we're down. There should be only.
Oh, that's right,
you killed him.
Did I not?
So only guy is left is Ragnarok?
She did strike two targets.
She did.
And did I kill one of them, the minion?
Yeah, you killed it.
So I get to do.
Skulls.
Great. And did I administer damage?
Six. Nicely done.
Six skulls on the board!
Listen, nicely you're welcome, done. I'm back.
Which direction is it? Ragnarok is away from me. I will flank him.
Oh!
Subscriber.
I wish Janie was here.
Welcome, Toenail, or Town Noel.
That was great being dead. You've never tried it. It's excellent. You get a lot of time off. I built two ships while I was dead. One of them went to warp 12, and the other one didn't work at all. And that was great. Aha. I'm still mad that you didn't bring me back.
He didn't have the
but
ability.
Thank you, subscriber.
Now,
it turns out.
Now she has been resurrected. But of course, there's a little bit of tension because the Vulcan is like, oops, I guess, but I can't quite feel it. For I am a Vulcan and our emotions are supplanted within me. Another!
I don't want to keep perishing like this! I do! I love it! I think we should do this more often on the McGinley.
All this dancing may make me crack a smile.
No!
I haven't danced this much since I was a license.
You would bring up right, huh?
It is a pleasure.
Ah!
I must apologize if you pronounced his name right. It was I who was wrong.
What did I say?
He is Griffin Argent.
Griffin Argent. And did he unsubscribe and resubscribe to resurrect the creature?
No.
And I know that name.
Well, thank
Wonderful.
You.
Wonderful, Griffin Agent. Welcome to Hyper RPG. A castle made of sand and imagination. Now, we move along.
I am flanking Ragnarok, and I am going to jump up in the air and try to attack him with both of my daggers.
Sweet.
Welcome
move.
Back. Thank you.
It's a real sick move. Dude.
It's a sick move. It's a mad sick move. It was almost an 18.
Jack, you're not quite yourself today.
No, I'm not. It's a 14.
Ah,
but
tried.
I wait. Because it's a flanking attack,
It's just plus 2 to hit.
It's just plus 2. Moving on.
So as you go on to it, it gets out on the back of Cutrod, and Cutrod uses his. He can move his horns.
Mm. Oh,
and he catches you. Throws you against the far
Jack.
Wall.
Jack! Oh! Jack!
Slide.
He slides softly down.
He'll be all right. Women have thrown him against the wall many times.
Yeah. He's fine. Yeah. Ah, Vulcan, your move.
I look at this creature. Its eyes. I can tell that there is a deep sorrow inside of its soul.
Oh, what is it thinking?
It thinks, if only I had more skin. Skin would make me feel more whole.
I could create some.
That is a tremendous idea, Janie.
You can create the skin. Cutrot hasn't had skin for over 300 years.
You create a sheet of skin and I shall take it and strangle it.
What?
I shall strangle the beast with this skin.
That's not what I intended, but all right.
So she moves forward and starts to create skin to
choke
the creature.
There's a little bit of grass here, tufts, which is organic, of course, and then you've got a little bit of quadriceptine here, which is.
Go ahead and roll your damage, Shulak.
Yeah,
she'll just keep talking.
Yeah.
What's your hit? What's your move?
10.
It is a miss.
She
took so long to create, and you move forward, ready to strangle with the skin that she was making, but the skin's not done yet. It is a miss. Now, boots.
Well, yeah, if you want to make a good skin, you got to take your time. And it's not like I have a lot
efficiency.
Of great resources here.
Boots, efficiency.
All right. I step forward to this guy. How are you doing?
Now, it is forever that I will protect the bones of my master. So it's kind of the same every day. Not good, not bad, but pretty much in the middle.
Well, let me say this to you. Since you rejected my skin because it took too long, I'll just have to have a little heat on you if that's all right. I'm gonna use some burning hands.
Oh.
So I'm gonna take my dilithium, I'm gonna combine them with a little bit of oxygen that I'm taking out
I've
of this
quadriceptine
rock
had
as well.
Hands.
That was a Risa incident.
Ready
also.
To go.
Yeah.
And I place my burning hands directly on you, which is D4 times 5.
You'll just never have Janie
15
burning hands.
Damage.
What does it do to the creature?
Oh, well, it takes your bones and it makes them drip a little, which I find is fascinating because I've never seen bones break down in this style. So I take out a little vial and I capture a little bit of your bones because I want to study them later if I get out of the gauntlet. And if not, I'll just look at it.
Cutrot is deeply, deeply confused by you having kept his dripped bones. But he is so distracted by his pain that he does stumble back forward.
I'm sorry
about
the pain.
You dealt your damage. And it is very kind of you to apologize to him. Well, none apologize to Cutrod except for Janie Boots. Now, Ensign Snow, your move.
I have no sympathy for the Cutrod. And I swing my hammer, my axe down in between his skull, hoping to split it wide open down
nice.
The middle. With 20.
20, wow. Oh, 20 total.
20
yeah.
total.
Ah, it's a miss. First hit is a miss.
It's a miss? Well, you haven't seen anything yet.
I come back
second
around.
Attack.
I just laid that down.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, you
did. I like the way you think.
That was more of a put.
Yeah!
Whoa! That's a 20.
I'm.
Roll again. We'll see if it crits.
Okay.
The 20's not an automatic crit.
Is that right, Ryan?
Wait, what do I do?
Isn't a 20 a crit?
To quit. To crit.
That's correct. To confirm the crit,
though. I have to 20.
So you gotta roll two 20s to get a crit.
You don't have to roll two 20s.
12.
Ah. I understand now. 12. So I had a 20 and now I've got to do a 10. Well, no, you had a 12.
You have a 12 plus your.
No, not with a 20. You can't roll with a
12 plus what?
I can't roll with a 20 die. For
your rules are confusing and
this
world is challenging. Highly
so
illogical.
This is unideal, but she rolled a 12 on her second roll plus her attack. Is a 24? Is that a hit?
It is a miss.
Then it's only an automatic hit.
Blast! Hit. Now I understand your confusing rules and complicated ways of altering it to your advantage.
Yes, indeed. But
it wouldn't be a fun
it.
Game if they didn't keep changing things on
that's
us.
That's right.
I like that.
I think we just have a hard time with logic.
You hit your you hit with your
correct.
First one. Or hit, you hit with that one, so you still got to roll your damage.
So.
With your damage of your axe, which is a.
Very, very confusing. Great. Two.
Plus.
Nine, which is 11.
11 damage dealt. Your axe swings true. What does it do to cut rot?
It this time, because I'm so focused on his rib cage, it actually lifts off his rib cage.
Oh yes, the rib cage is plucked off, as is everything above, including his arms and head. And the rib cage, it just it, because of the drips that have happened, it has a glue type substance that's at the bottom of its rib, and it sticks to the ceiling. But then his arms, they do fall back. And they land in the place of his horns. And his head lands upon his pelvis. And so now he has a pelvis, and in place of his horns, he has his two arms.
That's disgusting.
He's even more ugly.
Yes, I know. It's a really tough, it's a tough life in the gauntlet. Especially for Cutrot, where all I do is sit here trying to hurt things, never able to even feel that. So now, if I can't feel the pains, I'm going to turn it up against them. And then he turns to do a room attack to all of you. 14 plus 8 is 22, which means that it hits the first two of you. It hits Jack and it hits Chulok.
Not again!
So Cutrot, with his free horn arm, shoves Lucky Jack, who is not so lucky, against the wall again in
Jack.
That same way.
Deadman!
Did that just kill you, Jack?
Yep.
Oh, no!
22 damage, right?
No, 6, it is a 15 damage.
Oh, boy.
15 damage.
Not
to
looking
Jack.
Good. Not looking good. It's got me pinned.
Is it still in here?
It's still got, is it here? Has it got me?
Yes, he's got you.
Okay.
Against the wall.
I feel helpless.
And then 4.
He's got a horn in his trachea. I don't really know.
14 damage to Chulok.
I weather the storm.
Not like I'm doing much better over here.
I'm doing great.
I'm so glad for you, Janie. No potions for us, huh, Amantia?
That's fine.
Yeah, the potions are running dry. Why? Why, oh why, do the potions run dry? Tell us, will you not help them help as they try? If not, the tears will be streamed when they cry. Why, oh why, do the potions run dry? Now we move on to you, Commander. You still live?
Yes.
Life remains in you?
And it has me?
I
take
has
out,
done his damage.
I take out one
true.
Of my, I take out one of my grenades and I shove it into his rib cage.
Oh, when did you get a grenade, Jack?
They were given to me.
He no longer has a rib cage, Jack.
For the love of bologna sandwiches.
You put it
just
in.
Just drops right through.
It just
bounces onto the floor and rolls across.
Aha!
For one whose life is based in logic, guess correctly this riddle and a potion shall be yours. Guess wrong and a trap shall be your reward. Here is your riddle. I'm a mother and a father but have never given birth. I'm rarely still but never wander. What am I?
didn't hear this.
Can we hear one more time?
Yes, yes, yes.
For a mother and father.
I've never given birth.
I am a mother, I am a father, but I have never given birth. I am rarely still, but never wander. Answer the question true, and you shall be helped.
Can we all help, or just him?
No, no, no. Only the Vulcan.
I love riddles!
And in fact, if you get the answer correctly and speak it before the Vulcan, you all receive a trap. Now.
A mother and a father, but never given birth. What was the second half? One more time, please.
I am a mother and a father, but have never given birth. I'm rarely still, but never wander. What am I? Ubaldi, tell the master. Tell the master, Ubaldi.
I don't know.
They can't see.
Chulak, come on, please. You are only
this realm confuses my mind.
Don't worry, Master. I have the answer.
You got it? Okay, lovely.
The only thing I can think of, the only thing that comes to mind is something that is running out for all of us. Time. Is time the answer?
It is not the answer.
Oh! It is a tree!
A tree is the answer.
It germinates by itself.
Got it.
I am afraid a trap has been dealt to the Vulcan. Don't worry, I would not have gotten it either. But in fairness, I didn't even really try. All right, moving along. We have found that like a tree springing forth from the ground, we find a foreign, inconvenient goblin foaming at the mouth. Yes. Yes, from
Scream.
you see that little weird mouth door? That's where he runs out, like this.
Is that the noise he makes?
Yes, he does. Now,
very curious
Vulcan, you must speak in an accent for one turn, and you all will get 1d8 plus 5 of damage.
Whoa,
all right.
God.
All of us can damage?
Yep. All right. 5 plus 5, 10 damage dealt to each player.
Chulak, I know you didn't mean this, but you're a failure. To answer the riddle properly has been the death of me.
Well, me lassie, it's always been the death of me, because I'm dead too. Oh!
Oh no. This goblin. Also dead?
Also dead.
Jaden Boots.
I want to know what a mother tree is.
It's like a mother and a father, but it doesn't move because it's a tree.
That doesn't make any sense!
Yes, many things don't make sense. They make dollars, they make trees.
I can't believe my
crewmate. But now Boots stands alone, sitting in a pile of her dead friends.
All right.
Right, curious, are we down of resurrections? Is there a single one?
They have two left, unless they've used them. They have two left.
Two resurrections. Ah, two shall be resurrected, and I shall let you, Boots, either choose.
Dead Men and Snow.
Aha!
Thank you.
What happened? Was I out for long?
Oh, not long, Commander. Oh. I held down the fort.
Well done.
Whew. Lovely. See, death is but a doorway. One that opens, one that closes. And you have
what
a
happened
turn.
To Chulak?
He dead. Answered poorly.
Yes. Ah, that makes sense.
He spoke the wrong words, and death befell him. Now, will death befall you again? Janie Boots, I believe it is your move.
All right.
Cutrot stands before you.
Yes.
Still alive. Still holding on. Yeah, he has not. He moved his arm out and he's got you. He has his fingers clawed into the wall. So it's holding you up, but his arm is on its own. So he chokes you while he goes and attacks the others.
Fantastic. I'm going to use a fireball. And to make a fireball, I'm just going to grab a
Where
little
in
the
room,
bit
Janie?
Of the
sand. Where in the
right
room?
Here. I know. It's
Where in the room, Janie?
What's wrong with the fire? We don't want the fireball for outside the room.
The fireball goes boom in lots of different directions. Janie!
And that sounds really great.
Well, just kill it. Don't blow it up.
Okay. All right. So you don't want me to use the fireball?
Do anything.
It will hit everybody. But now you guys are back to full health.
Oh, yeah. We can handle it. Will it hurt everybody?
Yes. It will.
Okay, I'm gonna use a lightning bolt.
That works.
Yeah, I'm gonna use a lightning bolt, but I'm still gonna use exactly what I put it together, and I'm gonna throw
wizard,
a little bit of dilithium in there.
The wizard
and then
called Beans was not afraid to use that weapon. You all remember her. Go on, Forth. Use your move, Janie Boots.
All right, I aim my lightning bolt straight towards his finely chiseled jawline that must have once been handsome.
Oh, if you don't find it, I'm from now.
I'm gonna keep feeding with a little bit of this. Okay, and I will.
Subscriber.
I did. Jamie, that lightning bolt was super rough. proud of it. I might do it again.
I feel like I want to take an action with you back to the beginning. Masuma, Masuma, Masuma. I want to hear that all the time.
The ending
now.
Sounds
like Shy Guy Express. Hadn't subscribed yet, but he has.
Shulock!
Hey.
Shulock!
Shulock, everybody!
What was it like when you were dead?
Oh, it was a vast plain, lots of green fields and meditation spaces.
What's wrong with your voice?
I'm not sure. Things are a bit strange at the moment. Yes. I think there was some sort of hex put on me just before I died.
There was an accent hex put upon him, and he shall speak for this for the entire round. Janie Boots, what was the damage dealt?
It was... 6 times 5, 30!
Nicely done.
Well done, Lassie.
Dirty damage dealt to Kadra. Tell us, what does it do to him?
Well, since he no longer has ribs and his horn is in Deadman's throat, the other horn tips off, spirals down his body, and then just kind of cuts him along the knees, so his knees start wobbling all over the place.
You'll pay for this, maybe it's Kadra that must pay first.
Yes, he's wibbling and wobbling about. Now, he's in a weakened state. Ensign Snow.
Get him, Snow.
This is for killing all of us.
Yeah.
Except for me.
Again, I bring my axe directly down on what's left on him. There we go. 7 plus 12 is 19.
Miss.
So, I'm still swinging again.
13.
12. So I
it's a good thing we're really doing well against the big guys and the little guys are getting huge numbers.
That's right. So I miss horribly at Cut Rock.
As you think that slapping the knees of Cut Rock's gonna do him in, but nah, I fight for a king noble and proud, and I am gonna turn the blade sharp and true to all of you, sir.
And he does such a thing. He moves, and it is, 16 plus 8 is 24. It hits all of you.
Oh!
Cartrot is so wibbly wobbly that at first you thought it would be a good thing, but it makes him so unpredictable that he's just able to cover that much more ground so much quicklier, and he's just slashing and slishing and slashing and slish, slash, loose, slash, loose, loose. And what he does, the damage that is dealt is Kwa-pow, we've got.
Kwa-pow.
13 damage dealt.
Oh!
Is he still up?
He still stands. Kwa-pow still stands. Yes, while 13. His knees 13. Have become extra wobbly, while his one arm still holds you against the thing. But now, it is your move. May you remove, you can try to get it off of your neck. And if you can do damage to the hand, it does damage to the beast.
Great, then I will, since I'll grab out my daggers, I'll pull them out, and I'll just start chopping at it.
Yes, good move.
He learned that on Risa.
Critical fail.
Not a good move. Don't learn things on Risa.
Yeah. No, that's not a. I didn't do a lot of this on Risa.
Yes, natural one. You didn't do a lot of. You didn't do a lot of that.
No,
on
I didn't
Risa.
Do a lot of this on Risa.
It's good to know, Jack. It's good to know.
It's great.
I thought that's all they did on Risa.
Yeah, well, they do other things. Okay, it's great. Really has nothing to do with that.
And now the Vulcan.
Janie, we really must discuss your anger issues towards me as to why you did not resurrect me instead.
You killed me first.
Okay. Besides that fact, while I was dead...
You killed me first.
I had the opportunity to meditate upon Cut Rock.
Killed
me
first.
And realize that the weakness in this creature is in his name. He must be cut with a rock.
Therefore, wait, last time you did this.
It's cut rocked.
R-O-T?
R-O-T.
That's unfortunate.
But you can still cut him with a rock.
Do it anyways.
I will use trigonometry to leverage a boulder from the ceiling, and it shall fall upon his head.
Watch out for glitter sandwiches.
Yes. 6 plus 8.
That boulder?
It doesn't quite.
14.
It sort of shakes a bit, but it doesn't work.
It's been a while since I did trigonometry.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I mean, you know, at one point you're like, am I ever going to need this? Turns out you would have in the gauntlet, but yes. It didn't work. Boots,
All right, I'm gonna do the exact same thing I did last time. Get this little cut rock creature down on his knees and then falling flat on his face. I pull up one more concoction from all the things I see around me, throw in a little bit of dilithium. By the way, Commander, it is deregulated. Not deregulated, it is unregulated. Sorry to tell you that. Lightning bolt straight to him and I aim for his head and then split up my hand so it goes all the way up and down his body. And I damage 25.
Whoa, wow, amazing. Good work, cut rock. What happens to him?
Oh, does he die?
He's not.
Ah, okay, all right. So at this point, because I brought him to his knees last time, he falls down on his stomach and he just kind of like weakly flops his hands around like he's conducting a Beethoven symphony.
Master, why do you put me through this pain week after week?
I'm sorry.
Why?
I'm sorry.
What is it that I did to cut off and did to you? All I wanted to do was serve me kings.
Oh, poor Cutshot, this is the moment. Don't be deceived by him. He is a minotaur who has killed over 500 living souls.
I still feel
bad. 300 years, you've only killed about 500?
Jack, don't go with him.
That's all I ever came in touch with, sir. And one time Cutlot wanted to go to war, and the war against the two-leggers, but I wasn't allowed to because King Kankuk made me stay by his side, sir.
Oh no, yes, we really pinched him in the side.
Yeah.
He's afraid, he's alone, he is riding on the dirt now. Onto your Ensign Snow.
Cutlot, I have no sympathy for your bone. I've got a bone to pick with you.
Uh-huh.
No bones about it. So I jam my axe directly
nauseous.
Into him.
I feel sick.
Truly?
8 plus 12 is 20.
Mm-hmm. I miss.
Jesus, what? I probably can't.
Cutrot is, he's pretty good at driving.
I
die, you creature, die!
One more time.
Die, creature! Hey, there we go.
15 plus 7 is 22.
Ah, I miss.
Ah.
I miss.
So I ram and it doesn't work. I keep on running past him.
No, you miss.
What
you
do go, I, what
you
happens
just go to quickly through. Now Cutrot Lang decides to turn his dangers to your legs. For he is on the ground and there's only so much he can do. So he pulls back his axe.
I'm not on the ground.
You are still held up. You're suspended against the wall by his arm. So for you, if it hits, he's going to just squeeze you a little bit.
Oh, terrific. Okay.
And then the rest of you, your legs are going to be
hit. Kept my mouth shut.
But it is a miss. Cutrot misses.
Oh!
All right, Jack. It's time to give this bone some thought.
Hey! I'm going to keep supporting you,
That's
Snow.
That's great. No, these are great. You
keep
should do more of them.
You.
I'm going to lend a hand to get this thing off my neck. Nope, 19.
Nope, he's still held. So it's just Lucky Jack is just sitting there.
I'm holding
it. As a skeletal hand holds him against the wall. It's a very funny.
Kicking with legs, yeah, it's humorous. Yeah.
Sherlock, there's nothing.
It's got me with its humorous.
There's nothing funny about this bone.
I'm gonna give it the finger.
I can't support you on that.
Aha! Aha! Aha!
For she who excels at riddles, do you accept my challenge? Guess correctly and you shall have a potion. Guess wrong and kill a teammate. We hurt without moving. We poison without touching. We bear the truth and the lie. We are not to be judged by our size. What are we?
So she who excels at riddles, which of you is good at riddles?
Oh, I mean, I don't really excel, I just like them.
You said that you were
no,
good.
No, I said I like them!
It's you, Boots, so therefore now
Since you
must
brought
answer,
this on yourself.
Answer of Ubaldi's riddle.
What is the riddle?
The riddle is, we hurt without moving, we poison without touching, we bear the truth and the lie, we are not to be judged by our size, what are we?
Say it one more time, please.
We hurt without moving, we poison without touching, we bear the truth and the lie. We are not to be judged by our size. What are we?
I think I know this one.
Words.
Yes,
that's nice.
Magical
well done, great riddle. Well done.
No. Thank you!
Lord Baldi, you are a man among men.
A man among men indeed.
Nicely done.
Yes, 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 yes. Lord Baldi. What a tricky, tricky man indeed. Now,
this is my
drink of the potion. Drink of the gauntlet grog.
All right.
Get you of a potion.
I'm going to recommend you for promotion.
No, please don't. I don't want to come in.
I'm going to recommend you for promotion and transfer you off our ship.
I'm happy to be promoted.
Are you going to do one gulp?
Drink it.
Oh, thank you.
We're not on Risa camp, the commander.
Well done. Well done.
Pull up a potion parchment. Pick a good one.
I'm picking a good one.
Maybe the best one if you can.
They're all the best. Oh, this is so good. Consume control. Take enemies next turn.
Nice. Well done. Let's finish this.
Thank you.
Next turn. Ah, very good. Perfect. Is on the doorstep of death himself.
Good.
Now, whose turn was it?
I believe it is my turn.
I failed.
I shall now try the power of trigonometry to release the boulder upon its head.
I used trigonometry last time.
Oh, okay. What are you using this time?
The Pythagoras theorem.
You killed me first.
The theorem would definitely help instead of just hitting it.
Yes, for we all who watch the gauntlet know that sometimes math does more damage to us than the sharpest sword.
8+8.
It is. How many eights have we rolled? At least
many.
At least eight.
There are a lot of eights on this dice.
It is a miss. It does not hit him. Your mathematics will have to be dealt with a different day.
All right.
I feel like we're being mocked.
Because I know that we have potentially skipping his, I'm going to go ahead and not do the fireball.
All right.
I'm going to do burning hands.
Great.
So once again, I put on my titanium gloves. I bring the dilithium crystal into my hands. I touch them together, which you should never do. Never let the lines cross. And I...
Do not cross the streams.
15.
Ho, very close. Yes, you destroy it. What was the name of the weapon?
Burning hands.
The burning hands, they burn all except for his head. All of it.
Wow.
Yes, including the hand that strikes you, it falls and you're free.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jenny.
The hand burns up. And now, Kotrot is but a flopping head, but keep in mind that now he has one horn left, for the other horn was an arm, but it is gone, and now he is rolling around like a head, but don't forget, he still has teeth.
Sounds like a good opportunity for me to try out my golf swing. So I take my axe and aim.
Dear God, help us.
Thank you, Jack, for your vote of confidence.
I have a lot of confidence in you. It's the horrible pun.
Nice! Oh!
Big hit.
Oh! So upset about that, Jack?
No, I'm not. I still think the puns are terrible.
12
30.
Is 30.
It is a hit.
And I administer the 10 damage.
Snow.
Yes.
Yes! Kotrot is dead!
Yeah!
Well done.
Well done, Ed.
Describe his death for us.
I won.
Get the arms up top.
Making sure that. That's what happened.
I wouldn't feel right watching unless I requested a nice juicy hashtag trap.
And there's two traps.
Double the traps. Oh,
double the fun.
Double the traps.
I like it.
Double the craps that it takes on you. Ah, what? I am afraid that even though that moment was true, you smash open the creature's skull. First, before we administer the traps, roll for your skulls.
Skulls.
All right,
three
roll.
3d20.
Six.
16.
16.
22.
13.
22 plus 13. 45.
35.
35 skulls in the bowl, Mercurius.
Aren't you glad that I got beamed down here with you?
Yes.
I'm always glad you're with me.
Don't answer that.
I said yes.
It is logical that you would be with us.
As you smash open the skull of Kotrot, you thought that it was all fun and games and fun. Playground time, but no, inside of that is a freezing, deadly, swinging axe that springs forth, for Kotrot has a tiny little axe that when his skull is smashed, it turns into full form, and it hits the Vulcan.
Again, these perils!
However, here's what must happen. You must roll a 15 week. Subscriber!
Hold that shot!
Subscriber.
theme song.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. Wonderful. Welcome, R.W. Brenders. Appreciate you indeed.
Welcome aboard.
Hello.
Now.
It is logical to subscribe.
Swinging axe still. And now, if you are unable to roll a reflex save, you cannot move for a single round. But then there will also be physical damage dealt to the rest of the party that I will calculate now. So 15, reflex save.
Oh. 10 plus 3, 13.
Oh. Ah, the Vulcan is frozen in time for just a moment. Oh, but then alas.
Don't blink.
Just tickle.
I've always wanted
16
to do this.
Damage yeah. dealt to all members.
Oh!
The first of the traps. The first has been dealt. The first poisons are through, but now, of course, one more trap does still exist. Now, as they turn and they see their frozen friend and say, oh no.
Oh no.
Ah!
Subscriber.
Cumulus 888. It's like a cumulus cloud. It's like three clouds. 3 8s. Welcome to Hyper RPG. You are watching the Gauntlet.
Is that cumuli?
Nope. Just the one. Now, terrifyingly springing from the ceilings. Now, Chulok, he did so much work to try to free those stones in the sky with his mathematics, and he almost did it. But it's one moment too late, for the creature Cutrot was already killed. But suddenly, it finally falls through. But behind that, he is not able to use it as damage because springing forth are terrifying, brutal spiders!
Oh! Spiders!
Now, the spiders do crawl upon you. They crawl up your legs. Oh, how it hurts.
Do you remember that arachnid planet that we went on?
Now, but first, not only will you be harmed by these spider bites, but you, Ensign Snow, you must make a 20 will save.
I got this, Sky.
A 20 will save.
Right, Ensign
Snow. Bravery is...
I'll get the spiders off of you if you don't.
Is what you do in the face of fear.
A will save, or you will experience a D6 of damage.
Plus your...
16 plus what?
19.
Yes, no, you did it.
What
was
the middle?
20,
plus 3.
20 will save.
Plus 3.
So
you
got
19.
I'm afraid a
d6
of damage to you.
That's all right. Oh, God. Oh, God. Why are you hitting me with my own axe?
I'm just getting the spiders off.
You were actually administering damage.
No.
Janie.
Spiders still crawl upon them. And all members of the party do take 19 damage.
Oh, I'm afraid, friends.
No.
Once again. I leave you to go to my eternal shipyard.
These wizards are exhausted.
To build a little bit more.
Don't build anything, Janie.
Hope I'll fly to you soon.
Try to relax and enjoy yourself.
Save me a riddle. Or like, this is like an old folks home. You're lowering me.
Well, the way you keep dying.
Ow.
Stop dying.
I'm sorry.
She's on her igloo now, Jack.
Her what?
Her igloo.
Oh, I thought you said her igloo. I know what an igloo was. She's having her igloo right now.
Yes. But suddenly... One tiny spider was actually a magical spider, for as people who have been experiencing in the Gauntlet before know that there is a spider that is known as Frui. And Frui, the magical spider, hides amongst the evil spiders, but he is good, and he drops a healing potion into the mouth of Janie Boots, and she springs forth alive!
Yes. Nice. I built 3 ships this time, and none of them worked. It was excellent.
The nice one was not named, his name was Boris? What was his name?
It was a Frui. Frui the kind spider. Frui the kind spider.
The only spider I've ever
and in that moment,
do you need to get out of here? Do you want to come with us, Frui?
Frui,
come on.
Although I can translate for Frui. Okay. My spiderish is better than my orcish. He says, no, friends, I wish I could. I wish I could help you and aid you in your quest, but instead, I must go with a weak are preyed upon. I must go where the cracks in the design come true. For Frui the spider has never a day spent where he isn't helping those in need.
Wow.
And then in that, he chases the rest of the spiders
and they flee out of the room.
Yes.
Go boldly, Fruity. Live long and prosper.
I'm so used to people coming and going in my life like that.
Now, you.
Peace and long life.
Now, yes, peace and long life indeed. Now you have cleaned out this room indeed.
Yes.
So now you see a crack. A crack in the ground.
Oh. What about Tulak? We can't get him out of here.
We'll carry him.
So you're going to carry him. What you try to do is you try to attempt to use the liquid in the crack in the wall to loosen him up like the Tin Man from the Earth story.
Yeah.
Sometimes I
Janie, see if you can. That's
it doesn't quite work, but in that moment, this is not just normal water, but water in the gauntlet, which is transportative, and it transports you to this lair in the backyard.
No!
That's exactly how it works, Jack. Jesus.
Ah, now you have come forth in a land that seems not but made of stone and brick, but of mushroom and water and of all kinds of different natural formations. And at first it is quite pleasant. There is something in the air that puts you... Aha!
Subscriber.
Thank you, I'm not Bob Barker for subscribing. And no thank you, Bob Barker, for not subscribing. Wait, is he dead?
Bob Barker?
Yes. I think he's dead.
That's no excuse, Master!
Then all the respect to his family. We move along, it's neither here nor there. But alas,
Tulak just got
you
really
find
crushed.
Yourselves in here, and Tulak is now in a different position. And the air, it makes you all feel relaxed. You start to laugh.
Oh.
Everything feels fun, and maybe you should stop fighting. Why don't you just take a rest for a while? Maybe just sit and hug each other down by there.
It's okay that you killed me.
Oh, I love today.
As they feel just so in love with each other, they do not realize that
reminds me of
a
Grateful Dead concert I went to.
You went to a
spell
Grateful
most
Dead
dangerous
holodeck.
On the holodeck.
For little do they know that they have entered the lair of a creature most foul, a creature most slippery and devious. That is right, they find themselves in the lair of the satyr known as Kalikia! They're grateful, but then suddenly, two freshly pedicured feet do pop out of the water.
What?
And they just splishy, splishy, splash, forward, forward, forward. Oh no, children.
Deadman, those look like feet you would like.
Yes, you would. And they are distracted and ensnared by how wonderful his newly painted toes are. But children, as you know, only the piteous come across Calicius. Because while he's not the prettiest, he finds himself the wittiest. His toes are clipped, his teeth are brushed, its skin, it is the stickiest. But danger now befalls those who face the satyr called Calicius, who springs forth and immediately does land upon the tips of his toes. Ooh, hello, I see that there is a fun bunch here. But why? Why do you wear all of these coverings so full?
What?
At first I thought it was a new flesh pair of skin, but alas, it seems to be more clothes than even necessary for a normal creature to wear.
What's wrong with my outfit?
It's our uniforms.
Uniforms?
We serve the greater good.
But why would you want something to be uniform when the world is full of such differentiation? For variety is the spice of life, as is a cumin and a paprika, a spice that I like to put upon those that I like to taste upon. Suddenly, Calicius pulls out a tiny little bag that has rats in it, and he just starts kind of eating it.
All I heard was paprika.
Mm. Oh no. Calicius. He is a demonic thing indeed, but keep in mind, he likes pain. Pain helps him, it makes him feel happy, and his goal is for you to feel relaxed and to want to just stay in this lair with him forever.
For even though he has no friends, he thinks that everyone is his friend. For Calicius knows how not how to play, but indeed, Calicius strikes.
Actually.
Aha!
Does he?
Aha! Calicius reaches to get his spine sword, which is the sword of a spine, and he goes, slips out of his hands because his hands are, they're freshly hand lotioned. Yeah, he just used some lotion. Some new stuff, it's pretty good.
It smells like jasmine.
Nice.
Mm. I see you were distracted by us. Our apologies.
Time for an hashtag Uber trap after they defeat Calicius. While leaving the room, one of the champions accidentally trip a trap that the kind spider Fuey was attempting to deactivate. Unfortunately, Fuey gets one of his legs hurt and grows in size and enrages.
Oh.
It didn't.
Oh no. Bring it on! Let's do this!
Oh,
bring
God. It on!
But first, before you can battle Fruy, turn from friend to foe. Keep in mind that first you must get through Calicius.
All right.
Fresh out of a shower where he got some lavender scrub. His skin is looking extra, extra exfoliated today. But yes, he rinses, yes, he repeats, and yes, he wrings the necks of his enemies. Whose turn is it?
Sometimes we're at the top of the round.
The top of the round. But now Calicius' turn is blocked, but it's on to you. Commander, what should you do? Will you attack these different minions before you, or will you get Calicius, who does a sexy little side strut towards you, trying to
you like that, Jack, right?
A natural satyr's dance?
I use all of my powers not to be wooed by it and go straight after one of the minions.
Maybe I should do a dance for you like that,
18.
Jack.
Yes, please. It would really change things up on the bridge.
Yeah.
18.
18 is the total.
Mm-hmm.
Aha, it is a miss. I am afraid it is a miss. Oh, against the creatures. Yeah. Oh, yes. It is a hit. A fine hit.
And then I roll the thing. And it's a 4 plus 3, 7.
Dead! You have killed the beast.
I will. Should I roll my jammies?
Yes.
Well done, dead man.
Two skulls to the board. Right, kill. Yes.
Thanks.
Onto his head. Has he been frozen? We still haven't gone through a turn.
Yeah, we went through a turn. He should be unfrozen.
He's unfrozen.
You're unfrozen.
Did we?
You're all right. Yeah, okay. Because we're.
What
at the
did
top
you see? Oh wait, you were just here, frozen. Yeah.
He was just here.
Did you see what happened with the Calicius?
Why am I standing in a pool of water?
Never mind. Come this way.
Certainly.
I see that the pants have been wetted. Would you like to have a fresh pair of pants?
Don't trust him too much.
Disgusting creature.
What kind of pants? Janie.
Well, let's just say that they are not pants at all. There are a lack of them.
That's not pants.
It's more of like a Speedo, if you know what that is.
That's not pants, and neither are leggings.
That went out of style in 2050.
Ah, 2000. Style, all the while. Why shall I listen to you?
Is Cookie's wearing pants?
He wears like a little loincloth thing.
Jack. We only have so much time.
Everything Calicius wears is made of the flesh of his enemies. Oh. So previous slain gladiators.
Oh, he's got some skin.
He's big into other people's skin.
That's really
great. I will get to work
Vulcan,
right now.
Vulcan, do you attack the minions or do you attack the beast known as Calicius?
I shall charge up to this.
Aha!
Welcome back, Tunlock.
Thank you. It's great to be back.
Mine.
I know. Limbo!
Oh! Jack, you're cheating.
She doesn't cheat. She can do that, but I can't go the other way.
Jack, I never follow the rules.
So many favorites.
Right, Ryu.
There's a lot of excitement going on here.
There is indeed. Now, move forth into your move while I consult your assistant.
I shall. I shall run towards this Calicius, and I shall give him a strong Vulcan pinch upon his neck.
Great.
Oh, you went after Calicius?
Aha!
8, 16.
Hashtag trap side effect, wardrobe change. Today determined by the chaotic whims of Imontaic frills, nothing, red shirts, leggings. Who knows? Closing parenthesis.
Ma.
I won't insult leggings again, you guys.
Now, something silly indeed, for these are interesting clothes indeed. But of course, in the lair of Calicius, you have been tricked, and now you have gone into his wardrobe. And in his wardrobe, you will have to change your clothing. Now, take a moment and do such a thing.
All of us?
Yes.
Oh, goodness.
All of you find a flare. Now, I will take the moment to sing a tale. Now the Lord Man Calicius, he walked upon the street. For Calicius, he wanted to and fix his dirty feet. For Calicius, the satyr man with hooves that are clippy and cloppy. If he does not embrace his soul, you know that you can stop. He stop, Calicius. He is the trickiest, Calicius the trickiest, the stickiest laid man. This satyr will not want you later in his lair. For Calicius is not quite a man, you see his furry hair. Calicius will climb the mountain top to look for you. But if you are in his lair, no, you will be ensnared by the poo that he leaves around the house. Calicius leaves it round. Calicius leaves his droppings all around. And we're back. Aha! Yes, now you look much more like you're ready for the party, especially the one with the funny dog's head.
I got his extra loincloth.
Yes, for that, what he's wearing, while the Vulcan appears to be wearing a cute dog's head to those of you at Earth, in actual Deros time, it's the severed head of a dog. Now, keep in mind, and as this happens, Frui has gone through his transformation, and he thought that he was going to help you, but he fell into the trap, and then, ha-ha, another gladiator has entered the realm. It is the massive, enraged, evil version of the spider Frui. Ha-ha!
Why do you always turn on me?
Oh, that's horrible.
Frui, one-y and two-y, let me ride upon your back. Calicius does his signature triple backflip, and he lands upon the back of Frui, and now there are two of them, and they are coming to battle you, indeed.
Oh, my God.
How dangerous, how horrible, how noble.
Let us remember we can flank things, shall we?
Yes, indeed,
you must. Let us work together, team. We're a crew.
I take you very seriously wearing that outfit.
I am very serious when I give these orders.
Now, you are in a good position, for while there is a gladiator that might harm you, keep in mind that you are two gladiators in front of you that you may slay. Six D6s, D20s worth of skulls sit before you if you can focus and destroy these creatures. Now, keep in mind, there are plenty of skulls in this room. You can get them. You can double your score, triple your score on the leaderboard. Vulcan, did you complete your turn? I know that we got a lot thrown at us.
No, I rolled another eight.
Okay,
miss.
It is a miss. On to you, Boots.
All right.
Now would be a good time for a fireball.
That is exactly what I was going to do. Thank you, Commander. I do not need your permission, but I will take it.
It was more of a suggestion.
No, I'm with you. That wasn't... ignore me.
You guys work out your problems on your own time.
All right.
Just our relationship.
I take...
It's very intimate.
I take... No.
We're emotional.
Guys, we have important work business to do.
I take absolutely everything I can see around me because I know that these mushrooms have a little bit of lithium in them, which will make them a little bit of explosive. I get a little bit of that magic water, everything, and I create a
science! Go on.
Fireball, which I aim straight towards... I'm going to put it towards Calicius.
And Frui, it'll hit them both, correct, Rycurius?
Yes, it's got a 20-foot radius, so she must be careful where she aims it.
Oh, well, let me make sure that I'm right up close then.
Yeah, make
it. One, two.
You want to be close. It's a 20-foot radius, right? So it's going to go out from center, right?
Okay, then I'm going to put myself...
Because it's a called shot, yeah?
Yes!
I'm going to put myself right...
We're already wearing costumes.
#trap something feline.
Gryphon agent coming in, but again, for a little bit of a trick, a little bit of a trap, a little bit of a clip, 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 something feline about a cat.
I like cats.
Nah, don't we all? But a stinky critical mousetrap does spring forth. And by mousetrap, it isn't like those mousetraps that you have in Earth that snap with the cheese. No, it is an actual cat that traps a mouse. Now, fortitude save, or you vomit on your next turn.
Oh,
and that goes to roll the dice of destiny. It is administered to Ensign Snow.
Fortitude?
Now, the cat, yes, fortitude, 15. Will she get it, or will she puke? Oh.
18.
Yeah. Yeah! The fortitude save has happened.
I don't vomit. That's not going to happen here today.
Now the cat has gone upon
two
you.
Two shots
and you're,
of tequila,
like,
she vomits.
And you
vomit.
I don't like doing that to cats.
No one does. All right, 4 plus 24 damage dealt to you and
so. Oh my god, my best friends are now turning into my enemies. 4 damage?
14? No. 24 damage.
Oh my goodness. Ooh. Almost the death of me.
Almost the death.
Do I get to take this outfit off if I die?
Nope. It's not a bad idea.
It
smells. It's his loincloth.
It smells. Yes, it's Caligius' old loincloth. And Caligius does not do laundry, he just buys new clothes and leaves the old one in a pile. All right.
I've been there.
Yeah, yes. Like sometimes it's like, I don't need these socks anymore. Now, onto you, Boots. What was your damage dealt?
I'm doing it now.
You know, now, in the radius that you're at, are you going to hit any of your friends or just...
No. I have placed myself exactly so that I have got 2 gladiators plus 3
per
minions.
Square. Wow.
In front of me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's amazing.
But unfortunately, I rolled a 2, so it is only 10 damage.
That is not nothing. All right, so 10 damage is dealt. Tell us, what does it do to Caligius and to Frui and to all the minions? It takes them out.
Well, it takes one of Caligius's little...
Caligius's
carefully manicured toenails. Ew. And they pop up one by one. They're fake. I'm not pulling his real toenails off. It's just the fake ones. But you all know that vanity is a barrier and a hurtful thing. Therefore, this has hurt his pride, which is more damaging than spilling any blood.
Just really quick, it's 1d6 times 5 because it's a fireball.
Right, so 2 times 5 is 10, right?
Is it
d6?
Yeah. Yes, he was right.
Excuse me.
No, but good looking out.
Thank you, Commander.
Because you have to look out for your friends, because if you don't...
Hey guys, what happened?
Hey, Commander, when did you get the bunny ears?
Do not try to find logic in this game, Commander. There is none.
We have very little time, gentlemen.
Your turn.
Attack!
35 minutes. But don't worry, there is danger before you that you may slay. So, and then the creatures, and then how many minions did you hit?
3. So 2 gladiators and 3 spider woman, and then 3 minions.
This one over here, 4.
You have killed them.
Oh, great.
You have killed them all. Roll for skulls.
Is it d6?
And the big gladiators?
Or is
No,
this
no,
one?
No, they live.
Are they on fire? D6.
Caligius' toes were burst, and then Frui saw the toenails and thought they looked appealing and ate them and then choked on them, but just a little bit.
That's disgusting.
Yeah.
So one roll for each of them? D6?
One roll for each.
Okay. I have a feeling Caligius likes the toenails being peeled up.
He likes it.
Four,
he likes almost everything.
6, 3 is 9, 5 is 14.
14 goes with the board! Okay. 14 goes with the board. Now on to you, Ensign Boots. Ensign Snow.
I place myself in direct view of the enemy. I think it's a lyric to an ancient earth song. And I wield my axe yet again. I am beginning to learn how to use this item.
Great.
And I aim for the knees of Caligius right on top of the spider, because I'm not so sure that the spider won't be our friend soon. So I do that.
Hawk!
A hypo spray appears before the crew and upon closer inspection is revealed to contain a hashtag potion.
Yay!
Lovely, a potion.
Thank you.
Beverly Crusher.
Nice
job.
Thank you, Doctor.
You have fabulous red hair.
Dr. Crusher, all
and
the
your
way.
Intelligence.
For yes. the Enterprise.
Red hair is important, too.
Yes,
now,
it
the
is.
Potion goes... to you, Commander.
Yes. I really need
now, to drink of the
he
juice.
He needs it too.
I have to drink anything, or I'll drink the greenie.
It tastes kind of fun.
Just like a Bajoran sunrise, Commander.
I like your guys' way, you think.
Woo, that's funky.
Yes. Now,
which
we'll
one do you like?
Parchment. Which is the best? Ah, more
up more fire, more blood, more death.
Ah, oh, Greifen Agent. Wishing, wishing, always swishing. Swishing Listerine like it cleans the day. Now, read of your potion while I select of the trap.
Rainbow Shield, reflect one elemental attack back at the enemy.
Fantastic, pretty good.
Too bad there's no elemental
attacks. There are
attacks.
No elementals forward, is that correct, Rycurius?
I am crushing it!
Not yet, but there could be, you never know. For in the gauntlet there are tricks and magics of all sorts
of shapes. That tasted terrible, by the way.
No! Does it taste bad? That's not good. Maybe we should die. You know what? Gauntlet Grog, we could use a fresh reopening.
Do
ain't that right, Trogan?
Water? Is
this
kind of water now?
Terrific.
Aha, uh-huh, but the trap! Now!
Wait!
Oh. It's a trap!
It's a trap!
It was not Wesley Crusher, but his best friend, Greifen Argent, who is a mischief maker.
Oh.
A mischief maker. A half Cardassian type boy. With danger in his eyes. Now, it goes to you, Boots.
Yeah. But
it is a edible. It is an edible horrid pillar. Now,
an edible horrid pillar.
Yes, as you see in the corner, everything inside of Calicius's lair is edible. It doesn't mean you should eat it, but it all is eatable. It's like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory for you Earth people out there.
But
except everything makes you hallucinate. Now. It is up to you. Use your logic and wisdom, perhaps with the aid of your friends. Do you choose to taste of the pillar, or do you choose to not?
Oh, I really want to taste it.
Janie, you're always too
You like
curious.
To experiment.
I do like to experiment.
Whatever you want, I support you.
Listen.
Try what you want.
Whether this is bad or good, I appreciate the opportunity to try something new. I taste the mushroom.
You taste the mushroom. It courses through your veins. At first, it feels like nothing. It just feels like you ate something normal, like, you know, maybe a peanut butter and jelly.
Ooh, those are good.
But then, no.
What?
You start to see things. And it's not like it's things that aren't there. Everything just gets kind of wavy. The patterns start to kind of come at you and back away. And now, you think that everything's fine, and then you just start to walk into the water, and everyone says, no!
Janie,
don't!
Janie!
You walk into the water. And you are stepping deeper and deeper into the mud. And they're trying to get you, but then they realize that the water is starting to hurt you. You take 5 points of damage. And now, I am afraid that you take even more damage as you get under the water, and your friends are going to have to jump in and swim to help you. Because you go deeper and deeper into the water.
Because I'm sorry, I just really wanted to try it. I probably could have completely avoided that in every possible way.
That's what she says, but all you hear is...
I attack the water!
6 times 3...
Too curious.
6 times 3 is 18, 18 plus 5. 23 points of damage dealt. You finally are able to pull her to the shore. But in the process, you all take 6 points of damage.
Janie,
Janie
I
Boots.
Hope,
and I take 23.
And you take 23.
I hope that was worth it.
It was absolutely worth it.
Goodbye, my friend.
Oh, you're dead.
But now, Janie, what did you? Ah, but suddenly, the magics of the realm.
For Calicius does not want people to die on his watch, and if they do, he wants them to come back to play.
So Calicius uses his satyr flute to summon her back from the dead, because we also have the resurrection. Oh. So Calicius plays his sweet satyr song.
There you see. That was a
death by
song.
Hashtag trap smashing pumpkin colored sweater.
Some people.
Smashing pumpkin colored sweater.
Smashing pumpkin colored sweater. There's a trap that has been administered. Finally, Janie Boots comes to the ground. Calicius has re-summoned Ensign Snow back with his sweet satyr song. But not the one that makes everybody fall into a sleepy slumber. And now the Vulcan is going to get the next trap.
Again.
It's that hat.
You killed me first.
No saves, single target. It is a swift, light bomb that Janie has finally come back onto the shore. But in that process, there were strange urchins on the ground, in the mud. There are things on your legs. They are strange little prickly creatures. And you start to pluck them off. But they say, no, wait, you can't pull those off. It seems like they're starting to expand. And one of them does expand, and it explodes. But Chulak is able to grab them all and take all of the damage himself.
Wait, let me ask them what they feel.
Janie.
I don't know what they're thinking.
Janie.
Come on.
Give them to me, quickly.
It is only 11 points of damage, but Chulak, he takes all the, he takes it for himself.
Shulak.
And it's all right. He has little bumps and whistles all over him, but it is only 11 points of damage.
Are you all right?
You still
yes, I shall survive.
Shulak that makes lives. You really sexy, Shulak.
Thank yes. you. Everyone is feeling like everyone is sexy, for on the lair of Calicius, the air itself is filled with a suggestive agent. That's weird. That's not true. That's not real.
All right.
That's not real.
No.
They just like each other by their own volition. And Calicius still enjoys it. All right. So now, you have gone.
My
correct?
Turn. Yeah. No.
Ah!
Subscriber.
Thank you. Thank so
you.
Good.
I don't feel ridiculous at all.
I love it.
Stop this silliness.
We should do this on the holodeck more often.
I think we should take our gameplay much more serious.
All right, what time is it? Whose turn is it?
The time is that there are 27 Earth minutes on the clock.
Okay, all
right. Right, Curious, have we hit goal?
We have not yet
hit our goal. Now keep in mind that they have two gladiators in here. If we hit our goal, our donation goal, another gladiator, a new gladiator that you have not met, will spring forth into the realm, allowing them the chance in these 27 minutes to focus, not let the wizard ramble too much, and right. attack the beast.
Let's do it.
One trap or potion away. One.
Potion.
Right, so I'm going to move your hands in your pockets.
I'm going to move. Right. So is it his attack? Is it
our we attack? For good
it is
your
turn.
I will go to the opposite. How many? 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the opposite.
These big steps. It's yeah. all right.
Well, you tell me how big are these.
The little ones. These are 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Whoa! Ah!
Subscriber.
Justinius, you like that name?
I got it.
Aha! Welcome. Welcome, Get Jerked Own, I believe is how that's pronounced.
Oh, yes, Master.
Yes, Get Jerked Own, a new friend in the chat. Now, all right, you are watching the gauntlet where these Star Trekky folk are battling creatures.
I think we right. can agree.
Now, Commander, your move.
Let me get back to the USS.
I've moved to the opposite side of the creature, and I'm going to attack him. Does that mean he's flanked and I'm flanking him?
You are.
Somebody's
not.
Here. Is that flank?
It has to be touched.
One to one. Okay, great. So just a regular attack.
Regular attack to Calicius or to the spider?
I will take the one of my grenades and roll it underneath the spider.
Mm. Aha, to Frui. Ah, poor Frui, he was our
19.
Hey.
19 plus.
Plus 10.
It is a hit.
Yes.
29. And then, I haven't done this. Oh no, wait, it's not, it's plus 8, so my bad.
It's still a hit, still a hit.
Yeah. 3d6.
3d6 of damage dealt. Ah, Frui, once a friend.
Six.
Nice.
Three.
Nice.
Two.
Okay.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13.
13 damage dealt.
And now. It also does splash damage.
Splash damage?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means it goes in all directions.
Ah! So it hurts Calicius as well.
Yes.
All right, so 13.
Six damage.
Six damage dealt to Calicius. So, underneath, the bomb goes off, and there's a very, very soft underbelly of Frui, the once friend, but now enemy, and it bursts into him, and he wiggles like this. Like, aha!
Potion. Potion.
Damn it, Jack. I'm a hashtag trapper, not a healer.
Damn it, Jack. I'm a trapper, not a healer.
That was worth it.
That was. Is it worth it? Let me work it. The magical dice of destiny goes to, aha, Boots. It is your trap to be dealt. They're paying the poison.
I will not use mushrooms this time.
Damn it, Jack.
So in the process, a dangerous thing indeed. Calicius falls off of the back of Frui, hitting his head against his favorite mushroom, the purple one. And the purple one, it rips it off. And from inside of the mushroom springs forth The fiery, serious, pink, fluffy unicorns. Yes, the pink, fluffy unicorns are a creature of the gauntlet that even a Montioch cannot control, for they go forward and they do attack. Who do they attack? Players take one extra d6 of damage. Aha! All of you must roll a reflex save of 25 or above, or you take 1d6 of damage.
I cannot achieve 25 with my combination of skill and dice.
I also cannot achieve 25.
And I did not achieve it. And then 1d6 of damage?
1d6 of damage.
Wow!
Oh!
Missed. It didn't hit me.
Aha! It does it.
Dodged.
I took a what?
So the pink unicorns, they strike the other three. But now one of them takes the blast. For in that moment, as the pink fluffy unicorns, Jack does step out of the way as the things run forward.
Watch out, guys!
And then,
look out!
And, but then Chulak sees it heading towards his friends, and in doing so, throws himself into the way of them.
Chulak, you don't have to keep sacrificing yourself! I've been joking!
He's fine!
Chulak, so 6 times 3, 18. 18 plus 15 is 33. 33 points of damage down.
Oh, Chulak.
I am dead again.
Chulak.
Battle looks good on you, Chulak. Remember that.
Can I do your pong fa for you?
Yes, well, please.
You want to do that?
Yeah, I'm curious.
Ah, the Vulcan lays there dead.
You're tri-curious.
And in that moment, they all do gather around him and hold him close like hippies. And they weep and they cry. And then suddenly, the tears do mix with the vapors in the air of Calicius. And they go into his bloodstream. And keep in mind that the vapors that are in the mind from Frui the spider, where he is once good, he's trying to speak to you guys, but he's trapped inside of an evil body. But he sends a message forth in the spores of the air. And what it does is it heals the blood of Vulcan.
Whoa,
and he comes forward, and Chulak, he lives once again!
I have one question, which is how do hippies gather, truly?
With their hands held. Right, curious, have we hit gold?
Yes, Master, we have met the goal!
Yay. Have met the goal, and in that moment, the pink fluffy unicorn activity has been so crazy and uproarious, and that Calicius is baffled and confused because he hit his head against his favorite mushroom, and the reason it's his favorite is it makes him hallucinate, and then a rumble, a grumble, a scrumble!
Not possible.
And a gladiator so new that there isn't a little animation graphic made for it yet, and springs forth! Trifle, the bear!
Trifle like the dessert?
Yes, Trifle the bear. Not to be confused. Not to be confused with a more famous bear of a similar name. But yes, Trifle the bear. Friend to all, but not anymore. Hurt by the party, he was once part of a roaming band of adventurers that did travel the fantasy countryside, enacting certain missions. But now he is evil, for he was abandoned in the morning one time because Trifle wasn't helpful and they couldn't go into restaurants if they had him. So he was left alone, and now he is angry and trapped in the gauntlet. So there we go, 20 minutes remain. 20 minutes remain. Now, attack these things. Let us go forth. You have 3 gladiators before you. If you can take them all out, you could possibly turn this thing around. Come on, as you will, Vulcan.
Let's go fast.
Yes, I have meditated on the name of Calicius, and I have realized that he must lick our skin. We must cover ourselves in a dust that is much like paprika. So I roll around in the dust of iron ore and trick him to get close to me so that I can stab him through the face.
Aha! What a move.
8. I rolled
a miss.
There's so many 8s today. It's insane. So did you move? Where were you?
I was here.
I do a lightning bolt, and for the sake of time, I will skip it because you know what my lightning bolts are. Ooh. And I aim straight for
Calicius wants to be
Calicius.
This is my first. I think this is my first lightning bolt.
Yeah, I knew that was gonna come.
Yeah! Wonderful. Oh wait, I don't roll. Oh. I don't know.
You don't have to roll.
Save it. We'll use it for the next one.
3 times 5, 15 damage.
15 damage dealt to Calicius. What does it do?
Oh, well, it takes now his sweet little hands, and because it's lightning bolt, they hit him right through all of his fingers, and it burns his flesh, and it pulls it straight back just a little bit. Oh, it's so morbid for Star Trek. Star Trek has no blood or flesh.
Oh, no. I just went to Madame Ruhaha, and she gave me the most beautiful fingertips, and now they just look like they are melted candies.
We don't have time for your issues. Uh-huh. I place myself in front of my friends in order to do the whirlwind attack and attack all three of these beasts at once. I move around very quickly and do my 20.
Because he came off the top, didn't he?
Yeah, yeah, Clickius is knocked down here.
So but
he's still within hitting range.
Yeah, yeah.
You can just lay him on, yeah.
Oh, God. Nope, that doesn't even, I know it doesn't hit. Wait, it's a whirlwind. What does that mean?
You
4 plus 12 is 16.
16.
Yep, so I'm going to do it again. Try to do whirlwind one more time. Still didn't hit.
And it's an 8.
8 plus 12.
It's an 8.
It is an 8. It is a miss.
Okay.
A sweet miss. You got so dizzy that you thought it was going to be a heroic moment, and instead you
it was a really bad
air, remember, the air is thin in here. Is because of all the spores.
I'm getting self-important again.
Let's move faster.
Yes. All right. Now all three beasts. All three beasts do administer attacks to all of you. Now let's see if they hit, for I will roll their attacking moves with one sweet, swift die roll. And, ha-ha. One is a natural 20. Now let us see if I can crit. I do not. It's a natural 1. But it does hit. So 2 of them hit. Yes. Now, Calicius and Trifle the Bear do attack you, proud and true. Because Frui is able to, inside of his own mind, fight against himself and stop him. And because he doesn't want his friends to be hurt. So
Thank
the monster
you,
outside stops. But Frui, he holds back and he throws Calicius back. But Calicius does indeed strike his move. And it lands, and what does he do? He does a ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. 10 plus d6. You are all dealt 13 damage from Calicius. Who says,
now, you can melt upon the beautiful fingers, but do not imagine that they could grow back
and spring into a way that I could have them do their own little can-you-do-the-can-can type dance.
No.
Can
no,
you
no,
do the boop-boop-boop-boop? Now, but Trifle the Bear roars, for you guys look like the friends he once had and no longer has. Now he has to hang out with Calicius and he hates it. And so now what he does is he turns, aha, have a defense, one turn. There's 11 damage dealt by the bear.
Oh,
he
goodbye, friends.
He just
batter
you. And no. then in a similar way to how he attacked the commander in the first room, where he just kept like, getting whacked against the wall, he just whacks the commander who goes kapoor against the wall and he falls down. Oh, Jesus. I think I almost broke something. I didn't, though. All right. What? Nothing. You're not. You did it. Aha! Now, your damage is dealt. On to you, sir.
Ah! On to me.
Aren't you dead?
No. I've got 2 hit points left.
Oh.
Aren't you dead?
Was I hit?
Yeah, we all got hit.
Did we all get hit with 11?
You all just got hit twice.
I'm dead.
She's dead. Janie Boots lays dead.
Am I resurrected?
Yes. In fact, hold on. I'll do it this time. Ba-boom. She's back.
All right.
I take another grenade.
I'm not caring
and
about
I,
your death so much anymore.
Thank you.
Calicius
is laying on his prone, or is he, can I get?
Calicius is administering, he takes out his own personal nail care kit. And he's in the corner, he's already dealt with you guys, and now he's in the corner trying to salvage the manicure that he spent last month rent on.
Great, then I will...
He still owes it to me.
Can I flank him from here, or am I flanked to the spider?
You can flank him, yes.
Great.
You can flank him. Yeah, you double flanked. Ah, smart. Our commander still winded.
Commander, yes. You can't quit on us.
I'm
commander.
Not quitting, I'm thinking about retiring, though.
You must not give up hope, Commander.
All right.
Now, Turok, the Vulcan.
Yes. I have found a sword upon the ground, and I shall try to slay the bear.
So at the end, you're going to use a sword?
Yes.
Great. Terrific.
I just found one.
There
hasn't been one conveniently within reach.
Trifle the bear.
14 plus 8, 22.
Hit!
Yes!
Wonderful,
yes.
Finally.
You strike the bear.
Yes, I do.
Roll for damage and tell us what it does.
7 plus 5, 12.
Nice.
Hey.
12 damage dealt, the first strike to Trifle the Bear. And he has a flashback to that time that he was told to wait in the animal section when everybody went in to get beers, and he said, I can drink beers, in his own mind, though, it really sounded like it was this... the bear.
Friends, if you don't mind, I'm going to be a little sacrificial with all of you here, and I'm going to do a fireball.
Terrific.
Smart
Good choice.
Move.
Good choice.
Smart
okay.
move.
Get it done.
Right.
That was amazing.
I got it.
I know.
3 times 5 is 15.
15.
Not as high as I would hope.
Ruff. 15 damage dealt to all. Mm-hmm. What a fantastic move by you. Now it hits all three creatures. Tell us, what does it do?
Oh, they all knock against each other like you do when you're in a subway and suddenly it, you know, halts. And each of their skulls kind of bash against each other, and that makes them a little brain damaging. Yes.
Caligius is caught in between them, and he says, oh, boys, boys, please, after I've got my nails picked up, please. And then the bear goes, and then the outer spider just goes, but inside, Fruity the spider is like, oh god, I'm in Caligius' room, I hate this, hope my friends survive.
I am going to attempt a whirlwind.
Fruity is in the dark place.
Yes, yet again. A whirlwind one more time.
Yes!
15 plus 12.
Yes!
I'm done. 27.
27, it hits all three.
Cut.
All right, where's the 10? 5 plus, that's 14 damage.
14 damage, tell us
everybody,
what happens.
Well,
so I used to be a cheerleader, so I cry and it creates a whirlwind.
You have decimated your own crew.
I just do a whirlwind is what happens.
I missed it. What happened?
You broke Boots. You broke her. Look, she's gone.
She's so good.
I was so using the mighty math device.
I couldn't have said that out more.
Hashtag potion for Caligius.
Oh, Caligius can get the potion.
Oh, what?
So Caligius is like, for me. And he giggles a shrill giggle that makes you all go, now. What a potion to pick, for Caligius now does double damage.
Oh, God!
That's what I was hoping for!
My goodness! Why would you do that to us?
Indeed.
I feel like this mission is doomed.
Now keep in mind, all three beasts attack. All three beasts attack, but Caligius's will be the trickiest to the Killy.
There's a lot of ickiest words. Dead.
If you know of any ickiest rhyming words that I haven't used in my Caligius rhymes, please tweet at me.
All right, we're
but
ready
for
to
now,
die.
Both Trifle and Truey miss.
No.
However, Caligius. 20.
Does 20 damage?
Are you 21, 22, 23, 24?
Yeah. 21, 22.
24.
Suck
Yay!
It!
Ha!
Ha!
Suck it! You have escaped from the trial.
We're a naughty boy, Caligius.
His nail care kit, he didn't want to swing too hard because he just finally kind of made a little bit of progress on his cuticles, and so he just kind of half-assed it and he didn't quite make it happen.
This is the gauntlet. You come ready to fight, Caligius. Yes.
All right, Deadman, something higher than a 3.
I still get this for next turn.
You do?
Come on, Deadman.
I will, since the three of them are still together, I will roll another grenade into them.
Yeah, you will.
Yeah, a lot of grenade. It's not Nate.
I have to wonder if this is the
curse.
Gauntlet or the Kobayashi Maru.
A curse lies upon
I can't even cheat
him.
To win. For the love of God. I was
a curse lies upon
I missed.
The commander.
All right, Chulak.
On to you, Chulak.
I shall flay my sword at the bear one more time.
I was really impressive Trifle. That you found the sword.
That I have sent through with my dilithium. I just went and I went ow, ow, ow.
Nice. Yes. Well done. Get in there, whirlwind.
All right, whirlwind.
This time I just want to
throw. Back, everyone.
I want to throw my axe at him because I can't do anything else with it. 13 plus 12.
25.
Hit. And who are you trying to?
I'm trying to lick you so that he topples over onto the bear.
25. Are you flanking?
Yes, we are all
plus two to hit. You hit Caligius.
Yes.
Where? 4 plus 9 is 13 damage.
All right.
13 damage dealt to Caligius.
I have another round. I'm going to pick up the axe and throw that at him again. Jeez. Definitely not a hit.
All right. So it was 25 again. Wait, what was it? 13? What was your damage to Caligius?
13.
13 damage dealt to Caligius. Everybody at home, I am playing catch up, for I am balancing all of these three gladiators in the realm. My, oh my, oh my. 13 damage dealt, 47 minus, ba ba boo. Carry the two, we're so
Jack,
close,
Jack, if we
so
make
close.
It through this,
ba-ba-ba.
I'm gonna get recommended for it.
promotion.
I look forward to recommending you to a...
Yes, you are thirsty for it. The master has caught back up. Everything is fine. Okay, we have 8 minutes to go. On the clock. Now, Calicius and all of the beasts within, they do administer that hit. They are roaring and they are bleeding, and the outer evil version of Frui is extra frothing at the mouth. The anger is pure and true. And Calicius, 12, 12, 12, so 12, 8, that is 20. The first two do not hit. However, Calicius, he does hit indeed. Now, 8, 23
damage.
So you three get hit.
Oh. I have 24.
You have 24.
But I have 23, so I match it. Oh, I have to.
That you got to hit. That is a hit.
Ty goes to the AC. now Calicius.
How much damage?
Keep in mind that Calicius, as prancy as a dancy little thing as he is, he uses his hooves, which he has. He has like toe extensions that he puts on sometimes, and that's when he gets manicured.
That's disgusting.
I know, it's really weird. So he. He pulls, he's angry, and he got his pedicure, and he ruined it!
Yeah.
He spent his rent on that, so he pulls off his toe extensions and reveals his true hooves, which is sharper than the sharpest of swords. And Calicius, all right, so 5 plus 10, 15, 30 damage is dealt to you three.
I am
dead. Calicius lops off the head of the commander.
Oh, Jeff! Oh, no.
Calicius goes to the Vulcan and turns him into a Romulan. Yes.
He's really angry now.
He does a slight variation to his facial structure. He gives him plastic surgery in the moment, and he just
You're
has a little
more
bit more of a protruding
now,
head.
But you
now
still love your children, has been established in multiple episodes.
That's true, but I can feel things now.
And then Boots,
and I feel hatred.
He takes your satchel of dilithium and he smashes it and it burns half of your face.
I will get you, and I don't care about my face.
Good thing, please. Come. Come and do dance with the bear in the middle of the sunlight rise.
Ah, it is truly on right now. We have 6 minutes to go, and if you guys strike proud and true, you could kill all three of these creatures, and if you roll well, you could top the leaderboard. I don't know if that math is real.
Let's go!
Did get resurrected?
Yes. Hayototatama, Magalaga Samantadon, Tera Sandakora Santora, ha ha!
That was really weird.
The commander has returned. The commander has returned. On to you.
Back to one.
Do all this. Right. Higher than an 8, Desmond.
Gonna roll a grenade into the middle again and see if we can get a little something.
Yay!
So that
eight
is
times two,
plus
by the way.
8. Yep.
What do you have?
It's 16. 24.
24? Plus 2?
Yeah.
Miss.
What, 26?
Against two.
Well, it's in the middle of the three, but it's going outward.
Okay, it doesn't hit Calicius, but it hits the other two.
All right, so 3d6 for each of them. 5.
Hey.
6.
Hey.
3.
Hey.
14.
All right, Chulak.
To both of them.
Great. Ah, excellent. A fine smush indeed. They are getting down to the barrel, kids, but there are three gladiators in the realm.
Go for it, man.
I was going to talk to this bear about being a trifle, but since I'm a Romulan, I'm just going to twist his head off.
Great.
One.
One.
All right.
And in Romulan, that means 20.
Okay, I'm aiming straight for Calicius because I think he probably has the most damage. Let's try to get rid of him, and I'm doing a lightning bolt. 4 times 5 is 20.
20 damage.
20 damage dealt to Calicius.
Calicius.
He still lives.
Ah.
He still lives, but you have clopped off his feet, his mighty hooves.
That is correct.
And now he is.
Get him!
Now he
attack!
Now Calicius jumps into the water because he's good. He has incredible upper body strength. Like he's super cut. Like if you looked at Calicius, he was a model once.
I feel like if I strike my axe into the ground, I'll create an earthquake that will damage all of them. That's definitely gonna happen for sure.
Yay! 18
plus 12 is 30. And I administer,
30 to all of them?
10 damage.
Aha!
That's 10 damage.
10 damage to all of them.
# trap Calicius has them in a sticky situation.
Now,
10 damage.
The 10 damage is dealt. And in that moment, Frui is dead.
No.
Oh.
Good, that's what we want.
Frui is dead. Frui. You have killed him.
And we get to do this.
Yes.
All right.
And in that moment, you kill Frui. You stab him to death. And in that moment, the true Frui, the tiny friend Frui, okay. springs forth because you almost had him dead, and in his weakened state, your friend Frui cut itself out of it, and Frui the heroic spider did spring forward, but now you have killed a gladiator. Roll for 3D, 3D 20 for skulls.
Okay, 4. Jesus. 14, which is 18, and that is
35
skulls to the board, right, Curious?
Hey.
You have crossed 100.
Who's up?
RIP Frui, Frui is live, but now, no.
What?
Now keep him up, but before you get to attack, Calicius administers a final potion. Pastry-filled, moderate vines. Calicius, he's treading water. Ooh, now you thought you could come into my garden and just pluck the flowers without getting pricked by the rose? No. All right, 2 damage is dealt immediately, and then only a single target gets hit. But Calicius has, sometimes in his weakened state, control of vines. And it goes to Boots.
Ooh, bring it!
Boots is dealt 22 damage to Boots.
Ooh, that kills me!
It kills her. Calicius pulls the vine down. It strangles Boots and throws her against the wall. And she comes right back to life!
Subscriber.
I want to kill these things! I want to roll the dice! And I thank you for the resurrect!
Alright, okay,
oh god, that never gets old! I love it.
Yeah, she has sprung back to life!
Hello!
And Calicius, furious at it. Oh, I see. If the plants aren't going to obey me, then perhaps I'll have to do it myself. Calicius crawls forward towards you. It is your move.
I have one more move.
You have one more move.
I have one more. I'm going to do a whirlwind against these guys one more time. Them. God. That's 23.
23. You hit Trifle the Bear.
Okay.
You hit Trifle the Bear, but Calicius lives.
Okay. That's 6 times plus 9. 15.
Yay.
15 on the doorstep. On the doorstep!
Hurry up, hurry up!
Oh gosh,
oh,
so close. All right, they miss.
Go!
Jack.
1 minute left.
13.
13 plus 10 is 23.
23, it hits Trifle the Bear.
Jack.
4.
5. 9.
Dead, Trifle is dead. While you roll for skulls, 40 seconds remain. True lock, attack.
True lock, attack.
We have 30 seconds.
Using the other dice.
What?
17 14. Plus 4 plus
same dice.
17 plus 4 plus 14.
I miss again because
I
always
Boots, go. Boots, you can take him out.
All right.
Just roll for attack.
6 times 5 is 30.
Calicius and Trifle are both dead.
Yes! 5 and 9 and 9.
What was the ones you had?
I had 35.
35 and
23. 35 and 23 is 59?
59 skulls to the board! Now, 3, 2, the sands have gone, but in your final moments, you did slay Calicius the Beast. And in that point in time, while many who do not win on the leaderboard do get stuck here forever, people of the McGinley, you have fought brave and you have fought true. And if I know that there is such a crew as strong as you to go out and give some sort of mischief to the cues of who I loathe, then I shall release you from the gauntlet.
So we didn't get on the leaderboard, though.
You did not. 228, which is a particularly high score, but you came in third place of all of the total, and it was a fine move indeed. And now, for those who are accustomed to creatures of space, you did incredibly well. They have done things. They are the first ones to ever face Frui the Spider, the first to ever face Trifle the Bear. Give yourselves a round of applause. A round of applause. And then, for all of you at... Whoa! Hey! What's up, everybody? It's me, Chris Bramante. I was a Montiac the whole time. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God! All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching The Gauntlet. Please, please give it up for my friends, the Improvised Generation. These are good personal friends of mine in the real world. Now, they're gonna introduce themselves to you in just a minute, but what we need is the mods to get our MVP poll going. That is the most valorous participant. We will announce it, and then whoever gets that will come back for the wild card round. Of course, the top score of the leaderboard right now remains the Library Bards with the Last Action Heroes. Right now, they are slated to be the team that comes with me in the long form campaign against the armies of Krathicus Rakhtok. So get those votes going. Now, thank you so much for joining us for the Gauntlet every single Thursday at 6:30 PST, PDT, whatever it is, on Hyper RPG.
Yeah.
I am Chris Bramante, your humble Gauntlet Master, also known as Amantioch on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube, where you can find me and all the little silly things that I do there. You can also find me with musical improv group Robot Teammate.
Yeah.
For more information, please check out Robot Teammate. Right now, we are raising money for our new written musical, Turbulence, which is an intergalactic space race. You can find out more about that on robotteammate.com. Now, you can also find me at WhedonCon with my Buffy podcast, the Sunnydale Study Group, on May 20th. If you are a Joss Whedon fan, you will want to come to WhedonCon. You won't want to miss it. And if you're a Star Trek fan like me, you're going to want to know who these guys are. Introduce yourselves, Improvised Generation.
My name's Paul Hungerford.
I'm Rob Ullett.
Oh, is that all we're saying? I'm gonna say more about myself.
All right.
I'm Sarah Mountjoy Pepka. Paul and I are co-creators of The Improvised Generation. Okay. We create full-length episodes of in the style of Star Trek The Next Generation, but as you can see, we have our own characters and our own ship. We just finished our third season, but please find us on Twitter and Instagram as Improvised Gen, and on Facebook as The Improvised Generation. Sarah Mountjoy Pepka, I'm also a founding member of Ripley Improv. You may have seen us during the fundraiser this weekend, and we're currently doing Improvised Young Adult Dystopia, and you can find that Ripley Improv or Ripley underscore Improv, one of those, social media. Thank you.
Totally. I am Jessica Lynn Verdi. I am also in Ripley that performs at Impro Studio. We'll also be at Fringe doing Ripley Improv. And I'll also be in a play called Fair. It's the first time this play has ever been, it's a premiere of the play? That's what you say.
Yeah, so
it's
sure. Time. The world's premiere.
Of Fair, which is about a woman named Laura Fair. And I don't know, I'll tell you more about it on my internet. I'm at Jessica Verdi on Twitter or Messica Dirty on Instagram.
And you can see all of us almost every weekend at improtheater.com. You can come down to Impro Studio. Check out improtheater.com to find all the information about shows that we do at our theater.
Oh, one more thing, sorry. The Improvised Generation does have a performance coming up. If you happen to live in Orange County you're within drivable distance, we are performing next Thursday. I think it's April 20th.
It's my birthday.
Yay! Yay! Happy birthday! Hey!
In honor of Chris's birthday.
In honor of Chris's birthday, we're performing at the Orange County Improv Festival, so go find us there.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you all so much.
That's great. Everybody said all the things they wanted to say?
I think so.
Hi, Mom! And Dad, thank you for watching.
Say hey to all the moms out there. Everybody's got a mom. That's just science. My curious, you want to come talking to my chest and tell everybody about some cool stuff? All right, everybody. My humble manservant, Rock Curious.
Yes. Yes, guys, please go follow all these wonderful people. And if you're in the area, go check them out. They are awesome. If you didn't catch them on the charity drive, you missed out. But you can always see them on VOD or on YouTube or see them live in person. All right, so tomorrow morning we are going to be celebrating Star Wars once again at 8 a.m. PDT right here. So get ready for some more Star Wars fun coming at you. This morning was a huge success, and we're looking forward to doing the next edition of it. And then after that, of course, it's going to be morning update coming up at 12 o'clock. And after that, at 1 p.m., Shy Guy Express, our very own Matt Acevedo in the chat. Say hey, say
come
what's
over.
Up. Or just come over here, why not? In case you don't know who Shy Guy is.
Hello. What's up, everybody?
Is this beautiful? Hey, don't forget to speak into the chest.
Oh, I forgot.
We're like a Hydra or a Cerberus.
Hi, everyone.
Big space.
Come play Overwatch with me tomorrow. We're doing the insurrection. Well, we gotta work as a team. Do the things. 1 o'clock. Yeah, that's me.
Do it.
Do it.
Thank you, chat.
Teamwork.
And thanks for all the potions and traps.
Oh, heck yeah. Especially the traps.
Yeah.
And guys, after that on ERVR, we're going to have special guest Anna Brisbane and Steph Woodburn is returning to be the co-host with Ivy. Going to be super fun.
Ooh, I love that.
4:30 p.m. And after that, at 6 p.m., it's Death from Above, our weekly robot smash 'em up in space with special guest Aaron Knight. Following that up at 9 p.m., it's going to be Pencils and Parsecs, our Star Wars RPG. So get ready for another jam-packed Sci Friday here at our Opportunity.
Yes, awesome. Those are the things, everybody. For all the new subscribers who have joined us tonight.
I'm gonna find a raid target.
Yeah. For all of those people who's joined us tonight subscribing, welcome to the Thumper family. This is the best community on the internet. It is super amazing. And thank you again to everybody who helped us raise all that money for the Halo Foundation this past weekend. Thanks to Rai Rai, Zach, Lucas, Dustin, and everybody who didn't sleep a wink. Malika, of course, can't not say that. But everybody, you can return next week, which happens to be my birthday. The birthday of not just Christopher Bramonti, but also of the wizard known as the Montioc. For you can join us on Hyper RPG every single week at Thursday and enter the Gauntlet! Oh, we're back!
Whoa!
What happened? Hey, oops! I forgot to announce who the most valorous participant was. Did it come in yet? We're still voting. All right, so in the meantime, I shall tell you
what news of the world of Deiros, for Krathicus Raktok has moved into the land. He has come down from the north, and he has claimed the mountains of Lerum. And he has also found the rivers of Haishno, and he has dried them out. He has drank from them, and when, of course, Krathicus Raktok drinks any sort of liquid, it turns immediately to the blood of his enemies and draws their blood into the earth itself. And now he marches. Oh, how he marches, but he does not march with feet, for he does not walk. He is a vrock creature, a vrock of dangerous wingspan that flops and flips and comes down and picks you up off the ground like a eagle does the ferret. Ha! And shakes you around like this until you flappity-dappity dead. All right, did we, it looks as though it's
raid
pretty clear.
Raid command is in, let's get ready to raid!
Raid command is in. The VIP is VIP. Down. What? Can we announce it? Is it over?
Yes.
It is Janie Snow!
Janie Snow!
Winner. Snow!
Oh! Yay! Yay!
Snow, excellent work. Now, we're going to do a raid. So yeah, come back next week for the gauntlet. But for now, what are we doing, Rai?
Yes, come back tomorrow for more Hyper RPG. And we are about to raid the number one Alex. All right, he is an awesome streamer, a great friend of the channel, and he was actually just on our charity drive as well. So get ready to join him for some games fun. Be cool, have fun in chat, have a good time, mix it up, make friends, get ready. Okay, everybody ready to raid? We ready? All right. Go, Red, go, 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 go